Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the ITTF Uncle Pop Women's World Cup, coming to you live from Markham, Canada. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobrow, and this is the championship match. And right there is seed number two, Liu Shiwen, world ranked number four, 26 years old, has never lost a match at the Women's World Cup. She's a four-time title holder of the Women World Cup, and she's looking at her fifth title to be the very first to ever take five Women's World Cups. This would be an amazing feat over Zhang Yining and Wang Nan, two legends of table tennis, considered to be two of the greatest three of all time. But her opponent, Zhu Yuling, is the top seed, world ranked number two, and a very, very challenging opponent indeed. Ingrid Bogren there from Sweden. You can see on screen, will be officiating. Quick handshake. It is all business for these two. I've had a chance to talk to both of them throughout the week here in Markham, Canada. And I will tell you, there are no players here more focused than these two. The pressure on both of them to bring home this title. Now remember, Zhu Yuling's history, 2015, almost lost to Georgina Potta of Hungary after winning four straight games to get through it. Managed to get through and then eventually lost in the quarterfinals to Li Jiao. As you can see, you can connect with us, ittf.com, an outstanding website for table tennis lovers all over the world. From the ITTV, full matches to the history, statistics, articles, and everything else. And there are excellent articles from our writers right there on ittf.com. Hashtag ITTF World Cup for all your sharing with your friends on social media. And at ITTF World on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. I follow all the social media that I'm on, and I will tell you, it's an outstanding channel to follow. Also on YouTube, got the official ITTF YouTube channel for highlights, interviews, and everything else, all sorts of entertainment, off the table, and ask a pro anything to get to see the more fun side of the players. We'll see if one of these players might be the Ask a Pro Anything Player of the Week at this tournament. Let's find out. I guess the question is, who's gonna win the match? Zhu Yuling with their powerful spin shots from behind the table? Or is it gonna be Liu Shiwen with her quick strokes? Very fast, efficient style of play, heavy spin from in near the table. Only a quarterfinal result when you're world ranked number three is definitely underwhelming and leaves a lot to be desired for Zhu Yuling. I was actually in the practice hall when she had her lecture after the match. She played against Georgina Potta. She had three coaches standing around her. She was sitting, getting, I'd say, a good half an hour of lecture, private lecture from three of the great minds in table tennis. Liu Shiwen has definitely had her hardships as well from 2010 at the World Team Championships against the Singaporean women. Feng Tianwei has been the thorn in the side of Liu Shiwen over the years. Very interesting relationship indeed. But once again, with no Feng Tianwei here, on the way here, Liu Shiwen has not met her match. If anyone can challenge her, no one's taken a game yet, but Zhu Yuling will be the greatest rival she will face in this tournament. Last first match game of the entire tournament, and the winner takes all. The gold medal, the cup, and $45,000. There it is, right into the body. Liu Shiwen so fluid there to let the arm drag behind, mislead Zhu Yuling to move out to the forehand.
Left, one, love.
Little fly swat there. Seems like Zhu Yuling got it.
Love, two.
Solid start for the four-time Women's World Cup champion. Again, this is a best of seven match. First player to win four games. Hit hard. We saw some outstanding points in the last match, but that early in this match, as soon as a flat one comes in, the opening right here, slapped back once again for a winner. Zhu Yuling's reaction time is fast, but Liu Shiwen's even faster. Oh, no chance here. If Zhu Yuling wins this point, blitzing the table like that, that would have gone down as one of the great points, maybe the number one point of this tournament. Chasing it once, fishing this next one. Clever idea, but just no idea where the ball was going to go. I've seen strong starts before, and it's still too early in the match to tell, still too early in the game. Only 5 points have been played, but 100% of them belong to the woman in red, Liu Shiwen. Already a legend in table tennis, mega famous throughout China and the world of table tennis. But she will go down on the books as a record holder if she takes this match. Oh, top edge of the racket from behind the table. A bit of topspin to help out Zhu Yuling from off. A lot of people ask, how do I lob better when I'm way behind the table? How can I be effective? Not even a lob, just sort of a fishing shot, keeping it on the table with heavy topspin, as heavy as she can get without a full racket stroke. And it makes the ball jump away from the net. Dignitaries and VIPs on the lush couches behind that Polar Naturals sign. Could see them up and clapping. So 2 points in a row, the first two for Zhu Yuling. Really turning it up a bit in terms of pace. While she got 1 point from behind the table, the backhand to set it up, and then covering the middle. It's interesting, I think she did leave an opening on the forehand side. Liu Shiwen's gonna miss it from time to time. But when she's confident, when she's comfortable. And a break off the top of the net. You know, nets and edges can be frustrating for the players, but from the last match, both players had some really exciting points that the crowd was thrilled to see off the top of the net. And just the same here, adding a little bit of tension, keeping the ball in play, changing up the rhythm here. Oh, murderous forehand. Even cross court, that's not an easy shot, but to play it down the line, a parallel winner. Low, deep on the table. How does that happen? How can you be that confident to even take that shot? So 4 points in a row from Zhu Yuling. Oh, back edge of the table for Liu Shiwen. Now, maybe I misheard it. Was it the top of the net? Doesn't seem to be making a fuss here. I thought that caught the back edge of the table.
Play, please.
Okay. I think Liu Shiwen's saying, I don't know what she's saying. Sore back, sore neck? Bra strap issue? Yeah, I think so. I can tell you from experience that can be annoying. Maybe. Interesting. Just a twist? Well, there are special bras for sports. Have to imagine might be used. Now, that's the question. That's the replay that I wanted to see. I don't know. So as the wardrobe malfunction gets fixed, the score seems to be set at 5 points apiece. But that wasn't the conversation. The conversation wasn't about the shot coming down. I'm still curious. For your interest right here, let's look. That, wow. It's so tough to tell without the sound, but I heard something, and it looked like the trajectory changed ever so slightly. Sometimes things even get past the players in a full stadium. Look how full the stadium is here. It's really been an electric crowd, and I'm not just saying that because they're all blinking with their blue electric bracelets. But just the arena has such a good energy, and the players both want this so bad. After an exit in 2015 in the quarterfinals for Zhu Yuling, now the top seed, she has a lot to prove, and Liu Shiwen has a chance to go down as Liu Shiwen, the Women's World Cup five-time record holder. So exciting, fans all around. Standing next to me right now, a close friend of Seohyo Won, her practice partner for this tournament. So as the rackets are left on the table, I don't know what this goes down as. I don't see Liu Shiwen anywhere in the arena right now. I guess this is the type of thing, you've got a medical timeout for an injury, 10 minutes. Wardrobe adjustment is the term that I guess is what people use in the professional sporting world. And there's the look at the cup they are playing for. The Women's World Cup, well labeled right behind it. It's been around, what, 1996? The first Women's World Cup, this should be the 21st edition if I'm not mistaken. And a lot of legends to take that cup. Four times for Wang Nan, four times for Zhang Yining. And I just got some very private information that I'm sure you'd love to know, but I'm not allowed to say it on the air. Man, why would you do this to us, Adam? Ah, well, my Facebook friends and Instagram friends are gonna be messaging me, but I will tell you, I think I predicted it pretty well before in terms of the, in quotes, wardrobe malfunction, to keep it general. So Zhu Yuling is back. That must mean that Liu Shiwen is soon to follow, and Liu Shiwen on court. We don't see her blushing too much. I think in the emoji video that was released on the official ITTF YouTube channel, she made the big smiley face, and Zhu Yuling, her opponent, made the X'd out O face. This is the second time I've seen a point, and it was actually with Zhu Yuling before, where I thought Zhu Yuling won the point against Mo Zhang of Canada. And there was no fuss made. So tied up, 5 points each it is. Oh, and a service error right back. Karma, is that table tennis karma from the point before? I know a lot of hobby players will say, well, I guess it did hit the edge before, if something like that happens. Backhand to backhand, the timing of both of these players. Again, the Chinese national team, the masters of timing, taking the ball so early off the bounce. You get such a clear demonstration of that here. Second towel break of the game. Now both of these players have cute towels. Don't think that's a coincidence, but it is very important nonetheless. As wide as it comes, corner to corner, just wasn't enough to get Zhu Yuling off her rocker and off balance. But watch the finishing shot. That one might have even exited the side of the table. We've got friends writing me asking about the secret fun fact. Say it's Adam's secret, not Victoria's, although that could lead to some sponsorship deals in the future. Let's see.
Seven, eight.
So point for point, very even game one here. Remember, Liu Shiwen was leading 5-0. Looked like one-way traffic. Were we gonna see a 4-0 sweep? I don't know. Hair clipped back into place. No distractions on the forehead. Way behind the table, too much ground to cover. A lot of people saw the exhibition point with Elisabetta Samara, the exhibition points, where Liu Shiwen was playing against the lobs. Thought maybe Liu Shiwen had trouble, and I will tell you, when it's not an exhibition point, I don't think Liu Shiwen is gonna have much trouble holding back and taking the points. Not with Zhu Yuling that far behind the table. Although height is not on her side. Against lobs, if you're a little bit taller, it will give you an advantage, be more comfortable. Back edge of the table, Zhu Yuling. Oh, this is interesting. This is really interesting. Zhu Yuling's right. Liu Shuwen choked for a moment, I thought. Nice. Interesting, and she quickly says, okay. Man, that might have even caught less of the edge than the one that I thought hit the edge that nobody else did. And as always, I could be wrong, often am. Right there, back edge of the table.
9-8.
So from 10-7 to 9-8. It's not just one point, it's a point off of your score and to your opponent.
9-all.
Sharing is caring. The last few points have been shared right back. Third towel break of the game, and they are dead even. Trying to listen who the gyos are for. Okay, so the cheerleader. Ooh. This can't be more than a 45-55. It's about 50-50 here in the audience. And Zhu Yuling all the way back. What could have been 7-10. Three game points against Zhu Yuling was quickly turned around, and now it's a game point for Zhu Yuling from down 0-5 at the start of this match. More specifically, this game. Game one will be very important for Zhu Yuling to take. It'll be the first game that Liu Shuwen has lost in this entire tournament.
Play, please.
Spin shot down the middle of the table, saves the game point. Liu Shuwen looking at possibly a flawless cup. Well, if you're here in the stadium listening to this, please make sure you're walked to your car. Crowd getting a bit excited about their player. Oh, that forehand so wide in the touch game. Liu Shuwen lets that one just a little bit loose, and Zhu Yuling recognizes room for a full stroke. Look how quickly Zhu Yuling recognizes that ball's gonna leave her the room she needs for this backswing and that over the table contact. Much easier said than done. Game point back to Zhu Yuling, the top seed. Inside out, hits the back edge of the table. Wow, I thought it did, but I was trying to read the body language because the call that I had before was not the right call according to everyone else. Watch this, inside out forehand. That one's clear from this angle. Wow. In the heat of the moment, I think a lot of people didn't see this, but the quick cho. Typically you apologize for that, but that's how much this point means.
Left, 11 on.
Sometimes the passion, the heat of the moment, simply a reaction, and then after that you raise the hand. One more look at that edge ball, boom. Right into your right kneecap. Shuwen. Speedy Gonzalez of Chinese table tennis. This is illegally fast reaction time, and the ball, how does the ball not crack in the middle of this point? Stepped around. Throughout this tournament, I've been saying Liu Shuwen does not get pushed back off the table, but if one person can do it, it's that person right there, Zhu Yuling. After saving two game points, it's game point back to Liu Shuwen. And Liu Shuwen still flawless, has not dropped a game. Talk about living on the edge. Saves two game points and wins game one, 13-11. Takes back what she had started, 5-0, and then down 9-10. What an exciting top level game one in this best of seven. No coaches in the corners because they're from the same national association. But between Chun Bin and Li Sun, They are both very well prepared to be at the top of their game tonight. Let's see what happens. Just a minute in the corners and some highlights here for you to enjoy, and we'll be back for game two right after that.
I'm really happy this event is held in Canada this year. Right now we are ping pong, table tennis, central. All the action is happening here. Much more action to come as we proceed into game two. I'm having a good time, I don't know about you.
So the players don't have to use the full minute, and without a coach in the corner, often they won't. Keeping their focus coming back. They're both back at the table as Liu Shiwen clears the table to make sure that they're only honest bounces. No particles left on the table. Says, wait a minute, okay, now I'm ready. Zhu Yuling to start with the serve.
Love one.
And when we think about nets and edges, we saw a lot of that with Chung Yi-Ching versus Miu Hirano, but some of the most controversial edge balls, the very end of game one, we'll see. See if it comes down to the end of the match where we have such edge balls as well. Wow, wow. Surprise backhand whizzes past. Now it's not a coincidence, by the way, that there are so many edge balls late in game one. This is a combination of factors. You've got two very low trajectory, I'd say, styles of play right now. Both players trying to keep the ball low to the net and also trying to keep it deep on the table to push the opponent back. Fast long serve, the boldness pays off. Zhu Yuling trying a bold receive as well. She plays that softly, the third ball. It's gonna be no problem for Liu Shiwen.
Left, two. One. Two, all.
Now, Liu Shiwen is known not for her big strokes, but for her short strokes. Even there, the amount of speed she generated coming into that ball, that comes down on the table, it's gonna be trouble. This is what's great about watching two of the best players in the world. Liu Shiwen can hit a shot that's almost unparalleled out here. And Zhu Yuling can often keep it in play. A little bit off the top of the net again, but that parallel shot from the backhand. Liu Shiwen stepping back into the lead. Fans in the front row getting excited to catch a ball that could be a ball in the history of table tennis that will go down as one of the great dates for women's table tennis. But it really does depend on the outcome of this match. Breathing the chalk, the dust off the outside of the ball. Some players wiping it in their sweaty shirt, rolling it around in their pocket. Dmitry Ovtrov putting the ball in his mouth. Not too common we see a point end this way. Love to see that again. I'm sort of curious about the contact on that. At the first towel break of the game, it's a 4-2 lead, and thank you for the replay. Top of the net. Ooh. That's unusual. Normally a player would check their racket for a wet mark after the ball goes straight down like that with such a heavy topspin shot coming in.
Five.
Now, in the case of a wet ball, it is the responsibility of the server to make sure the ball is dry. If you lose the point with a wet ball, leaving a wet mark on your racket, and you are the server, too bad. Your responsibility. The opponent's serving, and that happens. They'll replay the point. Short to the forehand pays off. Outright service point. Now, as much of a lead as Liu Shiwen has, she was up even more last game, 5-0. And ended up being down, 9-10. Wasn't a perfect sentence. Oh, inside out forehand here.
Six.
Drying the palm off, wiping the sweat off near the net. that shovel serve, while Miu Hirano has really made it quite famous, I'd say the women of the Chinese national team were the ones who really initiated and made it quite popular to start. Very common tactic that's been very effective throughout the Chinese Super League and on the World Tour.
7-3.
But again, Liu Shiwen in the driver's seat at the back of the table in control. And no matter who you're rooting for right now, Liu Shiwen or Zhu Yuling, it's quite exciting no matter what happens in this match, because if Liu Shiwen wins 4-0, she didn't drop a single game.
7-4.
But as always, going to game seven can be a real thrill. Second towel break of the game, and it's an 8-4 lead for Liu Shiwen. Now my Mandarin's just so, I'm gonna try to get a translation on that. Sounded like it was actually English, just started with Liu Shiwen. And that counter to cover the middle. Wow. We saw Zhang Yiqing get power from the crowd. This one sits up a little bit. Flat shot covering the middle.
Eight, six.
Coming back in, we've seen the momentum shift. Zhu Yuling again, last game showing she can come back, but not enough to steal the game. This is a big point. This was around the time of the timeout for Zhang Yiqing against Miu Hirano. It's a very pivotal point in the game in terms of momentum, and that could be nerves. I don't see Liu Shiwen drop the ball too much. Oh, deep serve to the backhand side. Right after dropping the ball, plays a bold serve. Now, this is a very interesting thing that I've noticed. Sometimes a player who's nervous playing a risky serve actually does better than trying to play a safe serve, because they mentally prepare to throw caution to the wind a little bit. Tough to say. I know it seems counterintuitive. It's not going to work every time. They do say, what, luck favors the bold, the brave. This is something that the world-class athletes know all about. When to take chances. How to not regret or look back. Easier said than done sometimes. People getting so close to a title. Deep push.
7-10.
Now Liu Shiwen has generated a lot of spin in the past. It was game one where we thought she had 10-7 and the score was turned back. That's such a funny response. Two slow Zhu Yuling Jiaos and then Liu Shiwen Jiao. One game point save, third towel break of the game, and Zhu Yuling the first one to the towel. It always amazes me how the players can be so focused on the match at hand and still find themselves at the towel box in a heartbeat. I love it. Two game points left for Liu Shiwen.
Left, 10-8.
Now, if you're new to table tennis, there is no limit to the amount of lets a player can serve. In theory, Liu Shiwen can do that forever if she would live forever. Oh, a big point here in the backhand to backhand exchange. It's 11-8, a 2-0 lead. Still a flawless tournament. Not a game dropped. Liu Shiwen has her eyes set on that cup, but more importantly, she has it set on every game, the next game, and every point, the next point. But she'll be in the corner now, coachless. And as both players figure out their tactics for game number three, it's going to be an uphill battle for Zhu Yuling down 0-2. We've got some highlights for you in game number three coming up right after this.
I hope everybody is still happy. Everybody is still energetic. Come on. Put your hands in the air. 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 And clap, 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 clap. Oh, boy. I'm ready for game three. Are you ready for game three? Everybody, somebody.
And as the players come back into the court, game number three about to start. The door is officially shut. We've seen some doors kicked off the hinges recently in emotional matches at the Men's World Cup. Liu Shiwen, as emotional and fired up as she is, doesn't seem to have any anger. If she does, it's being taken out on the ball, but it's all very well calculated and focused. It's not anger, simply excitement, positive energy, motivation. How players convert their nerves. It was quite interesting to see. Again, that long serve right into the backhand. Bold play, but the point goes to Zhu Yuling to start off game number three. This is a nice variation in the over-the-table play. Soft, a little bit of side spin shot to the middle.
Two, one.
Now backhand to backhand. Liu Shiwen, very smooth in her strokes. Even when I was watching Kasumi Ishikawa in the practice hall with her coach, what they were rehearsing was the very circular motion, scooping under the ball to make a backhand from out in front, covering the middle. This is something that Liu Shiwen does almost to perfection. Oh, right on the line, a little bit off the edge. Zhu Yuling taking some risks here. And a good start for the top seed who's trailing. Spinny arcing ball, and then the follow-up, just a bullet bending away. There is a lot of passion in this stadium right now. It's tough to tell who has home court advantage. That one's not coming back so wide. It's gonna need the opposite spin or a different racket angle to come back from being turned that far away from the table. Wouldn't be the first time Zhu Yuling's won some points from behind the table though. But I think it would be not the best idea. The percentages are definitely in Liu Shiwen's favor when Zhu Yuling gets behind the table like that. Inside out with the angle. Liu Shiwen's so quick to turn the corner. And over to the towel break. Two quick points for Liu Shiwen. Stretching out the shoulder, making sure she's loose and fluid. Okay, Liu Shiwen fans win that battle. Now we've seen delay of game for the serving, but the fans here could completely stop the match just to see who has greater devotion. The allegiance to their players. What a great atmosphere for the players to be playing in and for the fans to show up to. If the standard is raised to this level on the World Tour, I think it'll be a sellout crowd for the rest of the year.
Four, all.
What an exciting time to be watching table tennis live. It almost looked like Lo Shiwen was lipping Jiayou for Zhu Yuling there. Just a coincidence that the stadium was cheering during that replay. Solid short game. Again, over the table, both players confident here. The amount of focus these players have to figure out their tactics for the next point. Liu Shiwen warned to play, please. In the middle of all these cheers and chants. Zhu Yuling explodes on that forehand. Liu Shiwen brings it back, and at the first opportunity, just gives a rocket of a backhand to win the point. It's a nice side angle view to see how fast the ball's actually traveling. Again, even in slow motion, it's just a blur of light. Liu Shiwen clips her hair. Zhu Yuling tries to keep her focus. Quick walk away from the table.
Left, five, all.
Oh, kick serve, and the ball jumps off the table. Again, Liu Shiwen at 26 years old. Is more experienced than any other 26-year-old there is, as far as I know. So she's seen a lot of serves. She's seen a lot of kicking second bounces. Figures there must be something on the table. Now, interestingly enough, it could also be to protect the ego. This sounds funny, and I don't mean it in the sense of conceited, but simply just your confidence. Cookie, Alan Cook, the coach for the men's national team in England, read a book about protecting your confidence and why sometimes players will make excuses. It could have been the light, could have been a little bit off. Now, publicly in their interviews, they'll say the right thing. They'll be diplomatic, they'll be humble. Sometimes they'll tell themselves, I was having an off day, so that they keep their confidence in the next match. It could have been the same thing for Liu Shiwen clearing the table. Must have been something on the table, not me.
5-8.
So this is potentially the turning point. Being down 0-3 against Liu Shiwen is not impossible, but it's as close to impossible as you can get from a game standpoint. So getting a game here to be down 1-2. Zhu Yuling eyeing that out, but down the line backhand. We've seen it many times, parallel winners from Liu Shiwen. Serve is not easy, and remember, from a wingspan standpoint, Liu Shiwen's not especially tall, maybe 156 centimeters, 5'2" to the Americans. This serve to get in so quickly, barely even any follow through. This is experience, this is someone whose technique, every part of her body's working together to add to all the power she generates on that shot, and now just 1 point between the two of them. Oh, the touch shot just a little bit too low. Again, clearing the table, not happy with that second bounce. Must be something on the table, not me. Sometimes it's a question of convincing yourself. I think we all know that moment when someone tells us something, we feel that they don't believe themselves. Points. Hands in the air throughout. You're watching this thinking, how can that possibly come back? And it comes back, sure enough. The backhand from way off balance. Liu Shiwen as fast as can be, and Zhu Yuling rushing through, covers it to leave it on the open table. Superhuman. I don't think you can get enough replays of this point. Have a moment of silence here for that point. Three game points for Ju Yuling to get her first game. And the deep push takes it 11-7. Ju Yuling is on the scoreboard. It is the first game that Liu Shiwen has lost in this entire tournament, the first dent in her record. Credit check, Ju Yuling on the other side of the table. Three exciting first games. And we'll be back with game number four as the players think up their tactics and you get to enjoy some highlights. Women's World Cup Championship match, game four coming up right after this.
Anybody's game, it could go either way. The Ju Yuling, 2017 Asian Cup winner, walking up here with the World Cup Championship. Or could Liu Shiwen add a fifth World Cup title to her collection? It's anybody's game, ladies and gentlemen. Anything can happen. I'm glad you're here with us. Let's go into game number four. Do you want more?
And as the players come back for game number four, it's tough to imagine better points than the ones we've already seen. If we didn't just witness in game number three, the point of the tournament, I have a feeling it'll happen in the remainder of this match.
Suit to serve, Lavon.
An unstoppable force meets an immovable object. It's one way to describe the championship match, the World Cup final between Ju Yuling and Liu Shiwen. Oh, off the top of the net, it comes down on the table, recovered by Ju Yuling in that swatting flat hit from the forehand. Watch this one more time. Very rarely does someone hit it with a little rotation, but Liu Shiwen just enough side spin on it to bend it out of reach. For Ju Yuling, again at her height, that is not an easy ball. We've seen Kasumi Ishikawa spill out on the table trying to reach a ball right in near the net. Clever idea from Ju Yuling, trying to keep the arm loose for such shots. I think floose was the term I invented accidentally earlier today. Fluid and loose. After that high-arcing, spinny backhand, Liu Shiwen sort of rehearsing, shadow-boxing it out. That low-trajectory backhand drive. Big point again, she's fired up. A 3-1 lead changes everything. 2-2 after losing two games in a row. That means they're tied and Ju Yuling would have momentum. That's end of the game stuff. But that's what some senses the gravity of this situation comes down to and why every point is so important. This is fire, absolute fire. I mean, I've seen both of these players play a lot of matches. They're two of the best in the world, but they are testing each other to the fullest right now. It's like there's extra motivation. When people used to question Zhang Jiko, was he motivated, was he not? These are two players who I can't imagine being much more motivated than they are here today. The light at the end of the tunnel is bright and shiny. The Great Wall of China, right there in black. I normally write down highlight points as contenders for the top 10. I think my pen has run out of ink already. I just don't have time. Every other point is incredible. This single match could be a top 10 video. If anyone has fear of missing out, it should be your friends who aren't watching right now. They are missing out. You are in the right place right now. Can't imagine a better sporting event on the planet at this moment. forehand flip, and it's countered right back onto the table. Reaction time again from Liu Shiwen.
Play, please.
Oh, they have been. I mean, I completely agree with the call to keep them moving, but wow.
Left, 4-3.
There's the angle off the side of the table. Rare to sneak it past Liu Shiwen. Again, she doesn't have big wingspan, but she has such fast feet, and that makes up for it. The greatest female player in history by many people, I'd say by the opinions of many people, is Deng Yaping, who stood 150 centimeters tall, 5 feet even. Actually, 4'11", to be specific. That's tiny. And I only bring that up to explain how important leg strength and fast feet and footwork is in table tennis. Pros and cons to being tall or short. Low center of gravity here. Ji Yuling, the taller of the two, takes this point. So the Ji Yuling fans got the last word in this point. The break between points, I should say. Ooh, 2-point lead for Ji Yuling. Now thinking through the long career of Liu Shiwen, how she's handled pressure, why we haven't seen her play the singles, the Olympic Games. Again, just uproarious reactions from the crowd. The reason that we haven't seen her play the Olympic Games is because when pressure gets turned up, the question is, will she crumble? There are two players in Olympic history from China, both Li Xiaoxia and Ding Ning, that have been proven against foreigners to deliver with much greater percentages. Maybe not much, but just enough that they were more secure for China. And as solid as Liu Shiwen is, having spent a long time at world number one and in and out of that spot, still she's lost to foreigners here and there, and she's lost matches under pressure, even to Ding Ning, 2015 Suzhou Women's World Championships final. Liu Shiwen up 2-0 in game seven when the ankle roll happened. And then after a 10-minute injury timeout, Ding Ning on an injured ankle wins the match in game seven over Liu Shiwen.
Seven, six.
So despite a 2-point run, lead taken right back by Ji Yuling. Funny, Liu Shiwen has a lot of respect from her fans. The facial expression, the body language out there is that of someone quite cool. Tyler Durden of table tennis out here. Ooh, a big show of war. Ji Yuling. Quite motivated, no question about it. We've seen it from both, but this is, again, possibly the tipping point. We will only know at the end of the match, and even then, we still won't really know. We'll just be speculating, thinking what's happening inside the heads of these players. A little bit off the top of the net, but no apology allowed, Joe. I feel like, unless it's a drastic edge, little clippings off the top of the net don't even count anymore for these two. If it's subtle enough, they figure, you know what? We can handle. And a very quiet clinched fist 4 game points for Zhu Yuling to continue her streak from down 0-2, just as we talked about earlier, to tie it up at 2 games apiece with momentum and broken confidence on the other side of the table. We will see. 26 years old, experienced, a long history in that head for Liu Shuwen. Oh, the big swinging backhand misses after all this corner-to-corner action. Zhu Yuling still with 3 game points. It's a fine balance between being aggressive, being overly anxious to finish something. I don't know what that qualifies as, but either way, she doesn't contact the ball. Second serve here. Oh my goodness. Does not come down on the edge. Top of the net just misses. I had to watch to see if they were leaving or if they were going for the towel box. So close. One. I'd love to see that from another angle. Hopefully we'll get to see that in the highlights. Wow, was that close. It was in ultimate table tennis in the Premier League in India that Marcos Freitas spotted one thing that nobody else in the tournament spotted. Not the players themselves nor the umpires. Very subtle missed call.
Net 8.
And I should include myself in that. I didn't notice it. Sharath Kamal didn't notice it. So sometimes these things get by. Oh, the push right at the back of the table leaves Liu Shuwen in trouble. Zhu Yuling 11-8 ties up the score, levels the playing field. And we'll see who takes the lead in game number 5 after a very tight game number 1. A lot of excitement left and the fans so thrilled to be here to see. Again, highlights will roll shortly in game number 5 to follow. Stay right here.
I want to see where are my true fans, where are my true supporters? All the people who are supporting Zhu Yuling, make some noise! All the people supporting Liu Shuwen, make some noise! If you love table tennis, I want to hear you scream! Yeah, that's what it's all about. It's about love, it's about passion. These athletes have passion, and I know you fans in here, you all have passion. We're so glad you could be part of this landmark event being held in Canada. Everybody's happy. Both athletes are still very much alive as we go into game number 5.
So the players back for game number 5 after being in their corners, planning out what they're gonna do here. I think the question is for Liu Shuwen, how can she make the game just like it was in the start of game 1? Crisp off the bounce backhands. I think serve and receive really are the most important part here to set up the points. It's tough not to laugh in amazement at how fast the ball's coming back and forth here between these two. Very few players in the world can hang in this rally as long as the other one has. One of my favorite matches this tournament was Chun Tzu-yu versus Du Hoi Kim. But I feel like there's a new favorite already. Looking like a boxer out here trying to stay loose. This game is crucial for Liu Shuwen to take back control here, grab the reins. Not easy to do, but from right at the back of the table, managing to brush up on the ball. It's tough because you don't have your legs behind you quite the same way as when it comes off the table. Oh, burned. Hung out to dry on the backhand corner. Thought she had won the points. Very rare at this level between these two to see someone who's so satisfied with their shot that they don't try. That's tough. I mean, that's just out of reach. Maybe that's another way to describe it. She was moving back to the center of the table, but right off the bat just realized there's no chance. She might pull a muscle trying to go for it. Every single point. I think this is the most vocal match I've heard from either of these players. And again, they've been quite present as the big four from China tend to be on the world tour. It's always interesting to know what title means the most to these players. Ooh, deep at the back edge of the table. Is that what Ju Ling was pointing at? Was she saying edge? If so, Liu Shiwen just Cho Lang. Wow. Yep, back edge. Ooh, a little bit shallower on the table. The bounce sneaks under the racket of Liu Shiwen. Let's do this one more time. Yeah, that bounce is way inside the baseline compared to usual. Stays quite low. I wouldn't be surprised to see her wipe off the table. Maybe we already did before. First towel break of game five, and they're dead even. I was going to say exactly where the crowd wants, but half of the crowd, well, half of the crowd is behind one player and half is behind the other. Maybe Liu Shiwen's got 60-40, who knows?
Left, three, all.
She's definitely had a longer career to build her fan club. And titles, too. This one's not coming back down. Again, if you think Liu Shiwen has trouble against lobs or fishing, just watch her when the points are for real. Deep on the table, a little bit of side spin and the inside out forehand to finish the point. To have that confidence to put so much side spin on it, even her follow through, she keeps her balance, recoils quickly. This is a perfect shot from Ju Yuling from under the table. Spins it right to the middle. That's probably the closest I've seen to someone exposing Liu Shiwen's middle. Does it qualify? Yeah, probably. Look at this one more time. Down low to the net, just a little bit more to the center of the table, and Liu Shiwen has to lean to take that forehand. The off-balance shot, quite challenging. Tied up at 4 points apiece. Right off the bounce again, the bending backhand. It fires me up to see both players so fired up here. One of the most exciting things in sports is watching players who want it so bad that their complete demeanor changes on the court. Crack the knees out there, stay loose. The conditioning, a lot of people forget, but these players, from running to weights and everything else that they have to do, it's more important for them to keep the blood flowing sometimes just to make sure they don't cramp up or get tight. The exercise they do between points is far from making them tired. Nice short stroke forehand from the back of the table. Liu Shiwen edging out into the lead by one once again. Ju Yuling with that subtle serve, much like Zheng Yiqing's serve, not much follow through. This is not a coincidence that the top players are doing that. To all the table tennis fans at home, something else to add to your game, to practice the subtle serves. Oh, high arcing ball deep to the backhand corner. Freezes up Liu Shiwen. This is a moment of indecision. If she tries to step around and play an inside-out forehand, the ball comes back on the table. She's got 90% of the table uncovered. Soft hands right at the back of the table once again. One step forward, one for Ju Yuling, and then one back into the lead. It's like the right foot and the left foot when you're walking upstairs slowly. This time she goes for broke, steps completely around, leaves the whole table open and says, you know what? I've got to make it count on this shot right here. I can hit it quality enough. This one's not coming back. I'll take my chances. Chole. 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 I don't think I can go any lower than that. 2-point lead now for Lucia, one to set apart the two. The tipping point we talked about. We haven't seen a timeout from either player. Not that I can recall anyway. I don't see anything on the electronic board down there.
Nine, seven.
It's times like this that we might see a timeout from Lucia. If not here, if she loses this point, to hang on to the lead. Again, without a coach in the corner, timeouts tend to come a little bit later in the match. Players quite focused on playing. Wow!
10-7.
The serve so bold in the follow-up third ball attack. I mean, we've seen how many shots Ju Yuling can keep in play with power. So in a tough moment here, bold play from the four-time Women's World Cup title holder. Three game points for a 3-2 lead. Ooh, two bold serves in a row. After a little break off the net, it's the third towel break of the game. Lucia Wen still has not crossed the finish line in game number five. Oh, no flash they're cheering now. There's a flash on the other side of the hall. They're pointing it out. All right. Someone just shouted, shame on you. That might be accurate. Not commonly said. Two game points for Liu Shuan. Ooh, Ju Yuling saves. What a save. And here's the timeout. Lucia Wen says, I need to capture this game. From 10-7, a 3-point lead and 2 points the other way on the comeback. She's quickly to the corner. She'll probably have a seat in the chair for a moment. Maybe not, just checking to make sure there's no wardrobe malfunction. A little bit of hydration. Not just cleansing of the palate and the mouth, but the thoughts as well. Tactically speaking, water on the hands to remove the sweat. Interesting. I don't know if I've seen that. If I have, I just haven't really been noting it. So what's it gonna take? Lucia Wen started this match with the serve, so that means she's starting games 1, 3, and 5 with the serve, which means she's on the receive here. It's a little bit of quick math from 10-8, odd multiple of 2.
Time.
Second serve for Ju Yuling. So Lucia Wen planning the receive here. It'd be hilarious after all this talking if they come out and I'm wrong, but that's a risk I'm willing to take. Lucia Wen has taken many risks throughout this match. And right now, this game, you know, I'm gonna keep saying that. It just gets thicker and thicker. The plot,
9-10.
This could be the determining factor, but in the end, it comes down to game 7, does it? Comes down to match point, no matter when it happens. No match is won without a match point. Oh, the soft shot, a break off the top of the net for Ju Yuling. No apology, a touch shot from Lucia Wen. Look at this. This is such a difficult ball. She plays it incredibly well, right near the table. but isn't able to move in for the softer shot after. Ball left out in front just a little bit. Wow. Table tennis typically a pretty polite sport. Maybe that's changing. These two are fighting. Deuce in game five. Wow, again! There's gotta be another word for wow. The highlights reel is just gonna be overwhelmed with wow. That forehand, the step round, it takes two here. Ji Ling's gotten many back, but it's game point once again. Fourth game point for Liu Shiwen. She's away from the table. Wouldn't be surprised to hear a play, please. Oh, it goes long. Oh, Ji Ling says it hits the edge. Ooh, I do not know. I didn't hear it if it did. I heard it, she says, ting da dong. Ting dao. 12-10 is the call. Challenge, does that exist? Not yet. Future of table tennis. Eat the end yet, just a little bit. Liu Shiwen says no. Let's watch the replay. Liu Shiwen's willing to look up at the screen, and I love that. But now she's walking back to the corner. She's like, I'm sorry, the call has been made. Ji Ling says video replay. Technically, that's not part of the sport yet. We can watch it now. I don't know if they'll allow it to factor in. Ooh, I think it did. Ooh, it looks like it did. It's so tough from this angle. I don't know if we can get a side angle from that. Wow. This is tough to let go. This is so tough. Ji Ling says we saw it. I mean, if this is the crowd voting, it seems like the crowd feels pretty confident that it did hit the back edge of the table. Wow, she is not giving up on this. I understand. I mean, it takes persistence for athletes to get to this level. It's not a coincidence that Zhang Jike has persistence written on the wings of his shoulder blades in tattooed ink. This is what it takes to get to this level. Maybe that's the best camera angle we have, but it's got the crowd in an uproar here. Man. It sure looks like it. I didn't hear it, Ji Ling did. Ji Ling wants an appeal. The conversation, wow! This gets really intense. The body language, Ji Ling saying, just look at the screen. This is so uncomfortable. So that was for the listening. We were trying to hear the sound. It was so fast in real time. The scoreboard says 3-2. And Ji Ling is out of the court. She's called the tournament referee, or maybe the deputy, to see if she can get an opinion on that. Now, generally speaking, the deputy referee will stand behind the umpire. It's a matter-of-fact call. What was witnessed by the umpire? That's how it goes down. 3-2 for Liu Shiwen. And you know what? This is the type of focus Liu Shiwen needs. I think she did give it a chance. She looked up at the screen. She had a conversation with Ji Ling. But it is calls like that that will get the crowd a bit behind Ji Ling. They feel like they can take justice into their own hands. And the timeout. This is a good call for Ji Ling. Mentally, you know, the mental game, the focus is arguably the most important thing in table tennis at this level. I think it was Jonathan Groth who said in our Ask a Pro Anything interview, you've got thousands of players around the world who can loop the ball with power time and time again. But mentally, to stay focused under pressure, to recognize your opponent's strengths and weaknesses, and especially their weaknesses, but both really, to know what to avoid and where to aim. And I'm not just talking about literally aim, but what your tactics should be. Require unbelievable focus, and to a sellout crowd, Ju Yu Ling clearly lost a little bit of focus at the end of last game. And it's a very prestigious title here. If we take a look at the last 10 years of winners, you can see Miu Hirano, when there were no Chinese players last year, broke records. But now that two players are here from the most powerful nation table tennis has known in the modern era, it's of course the top two players from China in the final as expected. But Liu Shiwen's name is all over this since 2009 in Guangzhou. Four titles, not a single match lost. And fair enough, I think Liu Shiwen has handled it quite well. Every once in a while, we see something that looks like it's a question, I'd say questionable sportsmanship, but not here. That is not this. Liu Shiwen did give a look. She did have the conversation, and the umpires agreed. She didn't hear it. It's tough not to argue when you feel confident that the ball didn't hit and your opponent feels that it did. It's one of the toughest things. When you feel absolutely sure that you're right, to be open to being wrong, it's character. And Liu Shiwen did look up at the screen and she did have the conversation. She looked to other people to hear what they thought. Mid chole. That's how important winning the point is. The ball could be hitting you square in the chest and you don't care because you won the point. Could have hit her in the forehead. She would have just blinked. We saw that yesterday with Liu Shiwen. I'm just trying to remember a moment. I want to say this is the most fired up I can recall seeing Liu Shiwen. Ooh, the brows are low. This is focus.
Four, two.
She is so determined. You know, we watch some of the most expressive players in table tennis, Matilda Ekholm, when she's frustrated, you can see her jabbing the racket at high speed into her quad out of frustration. And while that expression is not out here from Liu Shiwen, I feel the sentiment is almost the same. Same with that second guessing. I should have punched it back. I should have countered with the backhand. Oh, what a service error. Happens to the best of them. We've seen them all. Service error, and especially with the precision. That's right at the white at the top of the net, but it doesn't climb over. 1 point game. Well, well, well. The timeout. I almost forgot there's so much happening in this match. It is so dramatic. It's tough not to get ahead of ourselves and think about what the titles would mean for either of these players. But remember, Ju Yu Ling made a responsible call for a timeout when she was distracted and has really turned around the scoreboard. 0-2, I think the timeout was. Singles final at the World Championships was a match that just really raised the standard of the game. But this match right here, it's just tough to imagine better table tennis. I can't wait to see the ITTF Star Award nominations. Big backhand, quick off the bounce. The timing of Liu Shuan steps her back into the lead by one. She's right there waiting.
Play, please.
No, a second service error. And it's not like it happened in game one and again in game six. Watch this service error. You could see the contact there and you could see her reaction. The dimples come out a little bit with that wry smile to try to get her through. Stepping into the lead and then giving it right back. A little charity, the dimples come out again. Blowing on the hand to keep it cool and dry, the hand that holds the racket. Wow.
7-6.
Well, the crowd would has already gotten way more than their money's worth, but if this goes to game seven. A little bit off the top of the net, but it doesn't bother Ju Yuling. I can't even remember who had the top of the net or if that's the proper sentence. Let's see it one more time here. Too tough to tell. The sound really helped in that, but it's so fast from that angle. So two service errors in the same game and a difference of 2 points between them. That red light. Beautiful parallel backhand to bring it within one. Clever idea, really quick, but the positioning of Liu Shuan, she manages to generate so much spin without getting her body behind it from a little bit off to the side. Right back in it, 8 points each. Man, that red light came up even in the replay at the end of the point before. Table tennis fans around the world, it's exciting to get pictures from the front row, but check your lights. Yeah, that one. Maybe I'm just the most sensitive person ever, but the players have to imagine they notice. Back into the lead, three in a row for Liu Shuan. She's been questioned under pressure, not given the chance to represent China in singles at the Olympic Games. But real mental toughness out here over her younger opponent, Ju Yuling. Tied back up, third towel break of the game. Ju Yuling quick to get over to the towel. Remember, Ju Yuling is world ranked number two. She's the top seed. She's 4 years younger than Liu Shuan. She's the future generation. Her and Chun Meng will be in the same position that Ding Ning and Liu Shuan are in now, 4 years from now. So many young up-and-coming players to fill the roles. We'll talk about that later. 9 points apiece. No, and it's Ju Yuling who takes it. With all the pressure coming in, there's no telling who's going to win these points. Mental focus, staying on top of the bounce. The feet come together for just a moment and trying to change it up with the parallel. Look at this, the balance that Ju Yuling regains after leaning back to save that shot earns her game point. Oh. this. She's suspended. She's hanging on by a thread. And Liu Shiwen cannot beat her with the forehands on top of the bounce. Way behind the table, covering the middle there. And look at this one more time. Closes the racket and plays it out to the wide forehand to send this in to a deciding game number 7. This is almost too much. The bar is being raised game after game. Remember the controversy? Remember that? To set a 3-2 lead to Liu Shiwen's favor? That feels like it was yesterday. That's how much action is coming out here. 2 points again between the two of them. I'm gonna take a breath for a minute, and they're gonna take a moment to plan out game number 7. Enjoy some highlights in a few moments. Game number 7, the decider, coming up right after this.
Seventh game, Liu to serve, level.
So we're back for game number 7. Now it's important to be present right now, just a little bit of a flashback to earlier this year, the Asian Cup. Game number 7, Zhu Yuling wins 11-6 over Liu Shiwen. These rallies, the bar, it's like it's hit the ceiling and the ceiling keeps cracking open. There is no limit to how strong these points are becoming, to how much they can raise their level right now. This is why their stamina, their conditioning has to be so good, because when it comes down to the very end, the last game of the tournament, that they can keep pushing, that they don't have to be concerned about energy level at all. That's why the human body has adrenaline. I think about all the ITTF YouTube videos that I love to share on my Facebook page. From the top 10, this match alone will be viral. The highlights of this match will be a match that is shared for a long time to come. Still have a few weeks before the German Open. I think there's enough entertainment in this match alone to last the world that long. Oh, beautiful blindsiding shot. The parallel surprises Zhu Yuling. She's set up on the other side. Let's say she's a little bit more right-winged in that point. Quick decision. Knowing your opponent, knowing the patterns, knowing what they're expecting.
Left, 1-2.
Can't recall service errors from Zhu Yuling. If it's happened in this match, it's been overshadowed by the two recent service errors of Liu Shiwen. Wow, shovel serve looks like top and side. Not as much top on it. Liu Shiwen's got it in her pocket. Just the ball, not the match.
Net, 2-all. Net, 2-all.
Very faint net, just scraping the top of the net there. Second let service. Looks like it comes off the hand there. Again, for those of you newer to table tennis, the hand holding the racket is legit if it hits the hand and comes into play. So that's between the wrist and the fingertips of the hand holding the racket. From that close-up, it didn't appear. Tough to know. Either way, the shot misses. Zhu Yuling in the lead. Not for long. Back dead even again. First towel break of game number seven. Threes, you're under arrest. Threes all over the board. It's funny, I didn't mean for the arrest pun as they were resting for the towel, so genuinely unintended. A little bit of humor for this moment here because this has been incredibly intense. A little bit of relief. Deep on the table, that's going to be a tough shot to put past. Zhu Yuling can feel the pressure. That's one of those facial expressions we've seen today from Liu Shuan, but not so much before, not that I can recall. Tongue out. First, the shoulder shrug. And Zhu Yuling is going to switch sides of the table with the lead by 2 points. It's game number seven, so if you're newer to table tennis, to keep things even, an even amount of time on each half of the table, no advantage based on which side you start on, or as little advantage as possible. The deciding game, they switch. Zhu Yuling up by two. And it's game seven, so Liu Shuan starts the game with the serve, and right now at 8 total points played, has the serve back again.
Net 3-5. Net 3-5.
With a bold long serve, the shots to follow just don't feel like they have the intensity that Liu Shuan has brought to the match. And that was her gentle version of Matilda Ekholm's anger, hitting the quad. But really in this point, it almost seemed like she wasn't sure if she should come in with the explosive power, if she should try to change the pace a little bit. And that indecision seemed to cost her. And this time, the powerful shots, only one in there that was a little bit off balance. Everything else was as fast as could be from the backhand side. Still hanging on, but trailing behind. It's Zhu Yuling, the captain right now of this boat. Liu Shuan just water skiing makes it sound too much fun, but she's behind the boat, that's for sure. Generally, people water skiing are quite happy. People losing 4-6 in game seven, not quite as much. Ah! Big point here, 1 point game. No timeouts left. The expressions start to come out and the frustrations are really showing. This match has had it all. I think just shy of a chop. Controversy at the end of game number five. Frustration from both, the most vocal playing. Chose where we would once find apologies. And with all that pressure coming in, Zhu Yuling feels it, tries to bring it back, quick to her towel, a 3-point run for Liu Shuan after she loses the first point on this side of the table. She's won 75% of the points on that side of the table in this game. Deep in thought. The momentum is on Liu Shuan's side, but she's got the serves now. Remember, Liu Shuan has served 2 balls into the net in the late end of this match. Net Oh! And this is why you need high-risk serves. Something that's a little bit lukewarm, and Ju Yuling quickly steps in. Receive and turns for a fourth ball, no messing around. For all you procrastinators out there, a very human habit to have. Ju Yuling killed that habit in that point. No procrastination there. Drying off the hand that will toss the ball. Spinny ball to the middle. Wow. I'm just trying to do Lamaze or some sort of breathing pattern to make sure I don't faint before the end of this match. Fans watching at home can relate in the stadium as well. It's got to be tough for the players right now, but watching this. That was close to the first service error that I can recall seeing from Ju Yuling, but it stays on the table. This time it gets through. Ju Yuling saves so many shots in this rally. When you talk about never giving up and the point isn't over until it's over, this is the type of point that Liu Shiwen demonstrates. You really have to hang in there for every ball, waiting on the backhand corner with the forehand attack. Just really so focused in case she has to chase the ball to the wide forehand, the way Ju Yuling won game number 6. So Liu Shiwen 2 points away from setting a record, a world record, creating a precedent that has never been seen. She was down 3-6 in game number 7. She was up 3-2 with the controversy at the end of game 5 for Deuce, a 12-10 victory. Big point here to break the streak. Before that point, Liu Shiwen had won 6 out of the last 7 points. Consider that. This is an overwhelming percentage for Liu Shiwen. But in the short game, pops it up a little bit. And Liu Shiwen with that relatively abbreviated forehand stroke for a wide shot. Leaves the racket out in front to finish the point. Second serve, Liu Shiwen's either gonna have 2 game points or have her opponent with 2 serves at 9-all. And it's the latter of the two. Ju Yuling has the advantage. Third towel break of the game. And when you look back at choosing to serve or receive, there are pros and cons to both, but choosing to receive, and I can't remember who chose what, but the fact that Ju Yuling was on the receive from the start of this match means that she will have the last 2-serve combination that either player will have. Advantage to Ju Yuling. Fair enough to say, dries her hand in a tense moment. The cup will be determined by a mere 2-point lead. Match point to Liu Shiwen! Chasing it as it comes off the corner. Ju Yuling cannot convert the serve to a point. Covering the middle. Forced into the middle again. Racket head straight up. The backhand does not pay off to cover. Liu Shiwen 1 point away from maintaining her perfect record in the Women's World Cup history. Save match points. This is just world class and then some. Talk about nerves of steel. As fast as the feet are of Liu Shuwen, she can't chase it down when it's that wide. Deuce in game number 7. They will be alternating serves, and now it's Liu Shuwen with the serve under pressure. And it goes long. Championship point to Zhu Yuling. Watching Liu Shuwen hit her head. We don't know what the outcome of this match will be, but you have to feel for her. Again, Zhu Yuling, championship point with the serve. She takes it back! Unbelievable finish! Zhu Yuling gets the hardest shot we've seen on the step around, and she steals the match at Deuce in game number 7. A legendary performance. This will not be forgotten anytime soon. It will go down in history as one of the greatest women's matches of all times. The top seed, Zhu Yuling, at 22 years old, breaks the flawless record of Liu Shuwen. And if there's gonna be a record set by Liu Shuwen, it will not be here today, but history is created by Zhu Yuling. Unbelievable comeback. Drama of the highest order. Look at the scoreboard for the last 3 games. Only 2 points to decide. I cannot believe what we just witnessed. Going for broke, stepping around and hitting it that hard, and Zhu Yuling, the Great Wall of China, keeps it in play. And now for some words for the Women's World Cup champion here live on court.
2017 Women's World Cup champion, how does it feel?
首先恭喜你拿下世界杯的女单冠军，现在感觉怎么样？我想现在心情我觉得还是很紧张吧，我觉得今天的比赛自己还是因为紧张，我觉得我都眼睛都出现一些失误吧，对，我觉得现在这一刻很开心。
I still feel very nervous now, and because of nervous, I made some mistakes during the match, but I'm happy to win the title.
Excellent, excellent. And of course, you are victorious here in Canada, and of course, Markham and the Greater Toronto Area. We know how to have fun. We know how to party. How are you going to celebrate?
恭喜你在加拿大万锦市这个地方拿下冠军，那等接下来会怎么庆祝？
我想自己稍微开心一会儿吧，因为自己回国还会有比赛，所以这场比赛还值得自己好好去总结吧。
I still have many matches when I back to Canada. Well, sorry, when I back to China, and I still have a lot of to learn from this match, but I'm still very happy.
Well, wonderful stuff. Great to hear. We're glad that you had a wonderful victory right here at the Pan Am Center in Markham. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together one more time for your 2017 Women's World Cup champion, Zhu Yuling.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Liebherr World Table Tennis Championships 2017, coming to you live from Mesa Dusseldorf in Dusseldorf, Germany. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobrow, and sitting with me, 12-time Scottish national champion, Gavin Rumgay. How's it going, Gavin?
Yeah, super, and I'm really intrigued to see how this is going to pan out. The start is critical, I feel, for both players as they look to relax into the game.
And this right now is the time where every table tennis fan in the world wants to see what will happen between the man on top right there, Ma Long, the dragon, the dictator, the captain. He's world ranked number 1. He's the Olympic gold medalist. He's the standing world champion from Suzhou in 2015. And the only player that seems like a serious contender to even stand a chance against Ma Long is the player on the other side of the table who will be entering in just a moment. There's a difference in generations here. 28-year-old Ma Long and 20-year-old Fan Zhendong. He's world ranked number two. He's as powerful as they come. And he's beaten Ma Long once on the world tour, and despite having beaten him three times in the same Chinese Super League season, going 3-0, when the pressure is there, there seems to be a mental block or hurdle that is keeping Fan Zhendong from becoming world number one. And this will be a real test for the 20-year-old to see if he can overpower and outsmart, more importantly, Ma Long here to become the world champion at 20 years old.
Yeah, they've both managed to get through to this final stage relatively comfortably. Ma Long coming through a 4-2 battle with Timo Boll in the quarterfinal. That was interesting to watch. I was up there in the stands, really looking forward to that one as the game progressed. And also Fan Zhendong dropping a couple of sets to Ruin Phyllis, the German chopper. So that was interesting as well. So both have had a mini little battle to get through to this stage.
Right, and it's very interesting how we talk about the road to the final. Sometimes a player has a seven gamer or two, and they're a little bit more tired and fatigued, but for some people, depending on their stamina and condition, they're more warmed up and they come in ready to rock. For Ma Long, as far as being tested, you mentioned 4-2 with Timo Boll. Also in the opening round, Anton Schellberg of Sweden giving a real strong fight to Ma Long. It was a 4-2 victory for Ma Long, but to tie it up at deuce in the sixth game, Schellberg actually earned a third ball that he would normally make. So it shows a lot of potential for the young Swedish player, as very few people can really challenge Ma Long. Other than that, the fair play star of the tournament, Ovidiu Ionescu from Romania, took a game off Ma Long, but it was a 4-1 victory. And after that, Zhuang Zhiyuan, a 4-0 victory for the top player from Taiwan against Ma Long. And Zhuang Zhiyuan is one of the fastest. I mean, he's played Chinese Super League many times, but still, Ma Long was just very comfortable. And the scores, even had one 11-1 victory in one of their games. The others were a bit closer, though. And then earlier today against Xu Xin, a 4-0 victory. Now, there's a lot of conversation within the Chinese national team about Xu Xin's chances. And I heard that Liu Guoliang was saying this is his tournament. This is sort of the test to see, like, his last big opportunity. He just doesn't seem to have the fire that is required by the Chinese National Association. We see it from Fan Zhendong, we see it from Ma Long, despite losing a tough match to Xu Xin. We see it from Lin Gaoyuan. We saw it in the Marvelous 12. And on the women's side, very similar. I mean, the women's singles final could not have been more impressive to me. The speed at which they took these counter rallies and the placement was the highest display of athleticism, speed, and creativity. I guess at least within the time you could have creativity for opening up angles. There's the cup they'll be playing for, the world champions. We'll see Fan Zhendong on his side of the draw. Started off beating Per Gorell of Sweden 4-0. One of the best servers in the game, very difficult to play, but Fan Zhendong steady in that. An average of a little less than 5 points per game, it appears. Then over Alexander Shibaev of Russia, 4-1. Then a 4-2 victory over Ruin Phyllis. And again, for a defender to take two games off of Fan Zhendong, really impressive. So let's see what else after that. It was Koki Niwa yesterday. And the amount of championship titles, you can see the results here. Look how many championship titles we have. 2008, 9, 11, 15, and 16. So we're keeping track. I know Ma Long is chasing Vladimir Samsonov for World Tour titles, but as world champion, this is just dominant performance out here. And again, it's been a question of time. World ranked number two, Fan Zhendong, with explosive power on both sides. He's got the touch. He showed us that roller under the net clamp against Simon Gauzy that won point of the year last year. So with all these qualities, like Jonathan Groth said in his Ask a Pro Anything interview, the mental game is what really sets apart a professional and a champion. Lots of people in the world can loop the ball powerfully from both sides and have touch. What are your thoughts, Gavin?
Yeah, that's exactly it. You get to the world number one, two, three, four. It really is a mental game. you know, possibly on the world tour. These guys are playing with small injuries throughout the season, but you always feel when it gets to the really big pinnacle event of the year, it's the outstanding two that do get to the final, the world number one, world number two, thoroughly deserved for both players here on screen to be here in this final.
Yeah, we always feel, I feel like about a year ago, we look head-to-head between these two, and Fan Zhendong has only won once on the World Tour against Ma Long. It was in the China Open in 2016. It was a 4-0 victory, but Ma Long has won every other encounter. He's 10-1 against Fan Zhendong, although we do have to look at the most recent matches to really understand the relevance of these statistics. Not to mention, at 28 years old, Ma Long might be at his peak, but he's definitely at the peak. He's not still, we would think he's not still on his way up. He could continue improving. He seems to be maintaining his level, but there's not much other place to go than down from here. By the time he's 30, if he's still able to keep up this performance, Fan Zhendong's going to be 22 years old and still on the incline on his way up. Solid backhand at the back of the table. Early in the match, again, players still feeling each other out. They were actually warming each other up in the practice hall, interestingly enough. Now, we talk a lot about mental focus. In the practice hall just earlier, there was a member of the staff who had a medical emergency that was quite scary, and I noticed Fan Zhendong, everyone was watching in concern, but Fan Zhendong was very focused and made sure that he kept his head in the match for practice here. That could be very distracting, and there's no question it got in the heads of pretty much everyone there, you know, human beings feeling for one another. Not a point dropped yet from the focused Xiaopeng, Fan Zhendong. You know, you and I, Gavin, talked about his sweet spot and how big it is on the backhand side. That ball's a wide to the backhand shot, and he's moving to get to it, but still able to counter and generate a lot of pace. It's always like he's making his shot while moving to set up for the next. So fast. First point from Ma Long so far. And by the way, as we get started on this match, if you have any questions for the commentators, you can send them into the social media at ITTFWorld, at ITTFWorld on all social media. Hashtag AskTheCommentator. Gavin and I will be happy to take those questions.
And that's interesting there. Fan Zhendong opting in this early exchange to go with the little reverse serve. It's a very similar action to the Zhang Jika reverse serve.
Right, they are quite signature, and I feel like because we've seen Fan Zhendong playing later into most tournaments than we've seen Zhang Jiko recently, he's almost sort of taking ownership over that serve, the reverse pendulum. And I have to take it back to that meal in Kuwait a few years ago, 2015, with Ma Long and Fan Zhendong, and one thing Ma Long said is he said, "I wish I was fatter," which he said with affection. Like Fan Zhendong, so I could hit with more power. And the power has been so evident out here. Now, Gavin, I was talking to someone earlier from breakfast. Fan Zhendong had a plate full of Nutella and bacon, which you wouldn't expect an athlete maybe in the past to be eating, but he was loading up on animal fats and a lot of stuff to make sure he had an unusual amount of energy. Short side of the table, beautiful shot from Ma Long. We're seeing some slow sort of development on Ma Long's side of the table, Gavin. What do you think could be responsible other than the quality of Fan Zhendong's shots?
Yeah, he's just misfiring a little bit early on. You know, it's important that he can find a little foothold in this match, possibly touching a little bit shorter than he is at the moment to get that first attack into the right area.
There's the Saint Bride vase that they'll be playing for.
since 1929 in London to honor Fred Perry winning the title. 1929, a lot of people don't think of Fred Perry for his table tennis, but tennis and table tennis. A bit like you, Gavin.
I think it'll be a while since until we see that repeated, though. Someone winning a major in both tennis and table tennis.
I know Monfi is quite a recreational player. Oh, burns him on the short side of the table. When you have a set plan like that, it can be dangerous to turn the corner too early.
What was really good about that as well, Fan Zhengdong going against that side spin. A lot of the time you would find that left-hand fast side spin, the ball would ping back into the corner where Ma Long had ran round.
It's much like we were talking about in doubles, using the side spin to set up the placement for the third ball. So bravo to Fan Zhengdong. A little bit off the top of the net, but power for power, the backhands just explode one after another. Landmines going off at the corners of the table.
But that was better there, Ma Long, just settling things down a little bit round the net. That's where he can sometimes be in the ascendancy.
So while he's made a comeback by quite a bit, he still has a ways to go. Fan Zhengdong again, much like as far as the mental game, just like the other players against Ma Long who are strong underdogs, where Fan Zhengdong is not, it's important that he gets in early to keep Ma Long playing nervous and keep a bit of confidence on his side of the table. So quick with that backhand, just a bullet back down the line, a parallel shot anyway. Now 5 game points for Fan Zhengdong to take the first with authority. Look at the quads on Fan Zhengdong. The little wishbone above the kneecap. Well placed to the middle of the table.
And that's what you have to do. If you're not going to trade someone power to power, you have to think of another way to win points. That will be either little short exchanges around the net or little subtle changes in direction throughout the rallies.
So 1 game point saved. The serves are on the side of Fan Zhengdong. Place push deep on the table. Fast long push, can be so good if the surprise factor is there and it's deep.
And as long as you don't just go right onto a wing.
Right, well placed in the middle there by Ma Long. What an effort from Ma Long, and what determination and focus from Fan Zhengdong to finish that point. This is going to be in the highlights for sure. Look at this one more time. I felt like the patience of Fan Zhengdong was so impressive to keep Ma Long from getting the first attack. Very confident play from the 20-year-old, and Fan Zhengdong 11-7 over the standing world champion and Olympic gold medalist in game one. We'll be back for game two right after this. And as the drums were beaten, Ma Wang was beaten in game one as well. Now we saw a chance, I'd say we got a chance to look at the rackets and the equipment on the table of Ma Long's racket and Fan Zhendong's racket. It appeared that the sponge on Fan Zhendong's forehand was a bit thicker than Ma Long's. What were your thoughts on that, Gavin, with the table tennis legends and whatnot?
Yeah, obviously with the thicker sponge, that means there's a bit more of that trampoline effect of the ball going into the sponge and then accelerating out. So that straight away, that would tell us that Fan Zhendong has a slightly quicker racket than Ma Long. And funny, when we go back to legends of the game, the Swedish legends of Janne Vivoldner and Jörgen Persson, they always opted to use the 1.9 sponge, which was notably thinner than other players. So giving them a little bit more touch.
Excellent shot, playing the high risk. That is a very interesting thing to pay attention to. I mean, Waldner often thought of as the greatest touch of all time. And then what you're willing to sacrifice. People always ask, what would you recommend? I'm just getting started, or who knows? But yeah, different preferences for different players, of course. Fan Zhendong, the cannon on both sides, and the touch. Almost, if that one comes back around the net. We got another shot of the year potential here. The angle, look how far he has to go to get that. There was one point with Zhang Jiko where he was going the opposite way and slid back to recover a net ball. It was so amazing. Again, turns just early enough. I guess I should say just late enough to not give away the opening, but early enough to get around this ball and play it down the line.
And that's a sign of a champ. He was really misfiring in that first set, but he still has the confidence to try these shots. Just because they were missing in the first set, you've got to keep going.
Beautiful rally and an excellent finish from Fan Zhendong. You know, we're talking about confidence. For his whole career, Ma Wang was winning. He had a head-to-head winning record against Zhang Jiko, but when the match became important, Zhang Jiko would always steal the title, and it seemed like a confidence reducer, something that just Ma Long needed confidence, and in 2015 he found that and hasn't been stopped since, hasn't slowed down. But it seems like Fan Zhendong's finding some real confidence.
That's world-class play from Fan Zhendong, but I feel there, the last couple of points, they've been really good points for Ma Long as well. The backhand-backhand exchange in the second last point, he changed the pace. So he's not going to compete fast against Fan Zhendong. And then that second point there, he went to the middle. So he's thinking really clearly too.
And I think it was the Men's World Cup final. I'll look it up. But that had a very similar backhand-to-backhand exchange with Ma Long changing pace. Match point, it was at 10-9 in game 7. After Ma Long was up 10-6, Fan Zhendong scored 3 in a row. And that confidence on the backhand side, and sometimes not hitting it hard shows your confidence, that you're willing to change the pace and deal with the heat and give it right back to the opponent.
Hold it.
Again, soft touch to the rocket backhand off the bounce, allowing Fan Zhendong to open first. Very bold play.
And it was really bold play round the net there as well. He was doing a little bit more on the receive. He wasn't just touching short with less spin so that Fan Zhendong could spin out quickly.
Just incredible points to recover that ball from wide to the forehand to get back into the backhand blocking and fishing game. And again, Fan Zhendong is going to try to keep Ma Long pinned in the backhand and only go to the forehand in this situation when he thinks it's out of reach. That was dangerous. Ma Long got a good rip at the ball. But fortunately for Fan Zhendong, Ma Long was just so far back.
I think when you're in that situation as well, when you're as far back as that, you have to send in a ripping chop or you have to re-loop off both wings with a huge shot. Now, the lobbing the ball back on the table for 6 or 7 is just not enough. You can see Ma Long there looking to change the pace again.
Ma
lot of the conversation coming into this. Everyone was really seriously considering these two. There were a few others that were contenders, as we saw in the video, and between Lin Gaoyuan, Xu Xin, maybe Dima, Timo Boll, Zhang Jike. That is going for Broke. Gavin, you wanted to see a chop there?
Could have been the German Steffi Graf in the tennis. A nice little chiseling slice is what I hoped I was going to see there. It was all set up here. Look at this.
If that ball comes down, it's going to be deep into the body on the backhand side. Very difficult and ambitious shot for Ma Long to take. But again, with that confidence comes some fearlessness, and he will take risks. Big point to break the momentum. I remember 5-2 on the scoreboard, and suddenly it was a one-point game. Now, I brought up the past talking about the chances of these two. Everyone expected these two to be playing in the final. And you get a lot of different opinions about who it's going to be. And it feels like Ma Long still has the upper hand just based on mental maturity and experience under pressure. Looking at the results again, 10-1 head-to-head. Is quite a statement, because Fan Zhendong has been world number two for some time now.
And the way that the world ranking list has changed as well, and you know, triple points for this event, triple bonus points as well. If Ma Long was to win this, he really would stay ahead for at least another 5 or 6 months.
And I think he's got a bit of comfort there as well. I think it'll take a while, even if Fan Zhendong wins, before he takes over the number one world ranking.
Great start to this final, though. Both players playing some of their best table tennis, and this is where you want to be doing that, not out in the practice hall, right here.
What determination. This ball from Fan Zhendong from below the table is loaded with top and side spin, and relatively shallow on the table. Ma Long, look at this, about a foot and a half, maybe 2 feet inside the line, and Ma Long reaches forward, keeps the racket closed. You talked about that tacky top sheet on the Chinese national team rubber. Very closed racket, very important for Ma Long. Short side of the table, and the risk pays off. Ma Long with 4 game points to tie it up. This could be a 7-game extravaganza, and the way Ma Long is playing right now, he's definitely turning things around.
He's not won many points when it's been fast diagonal exchanges, so he's had to use that brain of his, playing to the middle, playing some shots down the wings.
Nice change of pace, soft with the first backhand, and Ma Long comes back with the speed after baiting Fan Zhendong into the first rocket backhand. 11-6 for the dictator, the dragon, Ma Long, and we'll be back for game three right after this. back for game three. Ma Long in red at the bottom of the screen ties it up. Again, the change of pace, a real success for Ma Long. Now again, we got to have some conversation at break. We were talking about world rankings and the new system. Looking at the points between them, it's actually much closer than I realized. Fan Zhendong might be able to come out world number one if he wins this match. He's fired up indeed. You know, the rivalry is interesting because the camaraderie of being on the same national team, practice partners and close friends, maybe even mentors on some level. When you're out here, it's all business, and the fight is actually a sign of respect, giving your all. Using the length of the table for all that power and speed.
You can see how much Ma Long has to think out there. In his other matches he can just play fairly standard, but here he's mixing the serves, he's mixing the placements as often as he can.
Nut ball there too wide, a bit of side spin on it, hooking out to the forehand side. So with the new ranking system, I have a chance to see what the world rankings would be, and Ma Long would still be world number one over Fan Zhendong, but Zhang Jiko would actually be number five in the world, and Wang Chunting would be number four. For those of you curious about the new world ranking system, it basically means that how far you get in a tournament determines how many points you get rather than who the opponent is that you beat. So if you beat Ma Long in the round of 64, for example, it's worth no more than if you beat, you know, the 64th seed. It will encourage more participation so that you have a chance, hopefully, to see your favorite players, the big four from China and all others at the top of the world on the world tour pretty consistently. Wow, too fast, so deep on the table. When he keeps it that close to the baseline, sometimes you question yourself to even know if it made it. You could hear that little tick before it hit the shirt. Maybe a little bit off the top.
And those of you back home thinking, oh, winner speed 75 kilometers an hour, that doesn't appear very fast. You think about it, sport like tennis, 20 meters between you and your opponent. In table tennis, you've only got 4 or 5 meters between the two of you. And this would be equivalent to someone like Roger Federer trying to serve and you're actually on the same side of the court as him trying to return that service. I mean, lightning quick reactions you need for table tennis.
Indeed, the reaction time. It actually comes down to equipment, not comes down to, but includes the equipment that you use that's built for this type of speed. The angle there that Fan Zhendong created with the backhand. You mentioned before how difficult it is for the wrist to go that way. The natural inclination would be played down the line. I think it was in doubles you talked about this. But Fan Zhendong pulling some magic out there from over the table. So well timed with that rocket backhand. Ma Long really seems to be setting up some plays and getting the shots he wants right into the wheelhouse to win the points. Fan Zhendong turning the corner, stays in at the table, gets the racket out in front to keep the ball coming back quickly. Look at that, still a bit of topspin on it with the wrist.
For all you guys and girls back home there, notice there, from a technical standpoint, the way that the elbow didn't move. If the elbow had moved upwards at all, that ball would have went off the end of the table.
Doesn't faze Ma Long.
And right after you talk about the elbow, we see when we would use that raised elbow, when you're in near the table and need to generate all the spin. Look at the Ma Long fan club there with the Ma Long hats. Tiaras, maybe. Got some interesting questions coming in here. We'll try to take them on towel break. So Ma Long up 9-3 as we go to the second towel break. Now this question I'm going to send to you because you're an equipment maker yourself, Gavin. The question is from Jakob Pfeiffer. Does one of the players use a carbon sponge? Now, generally carbon, of course, applying to the blade. And I know Ma Long has his own blade and Fan Zhendong is playing with a Stiga. Do you know the specifics and ingredients if they have carbon in their blades?
Yeah, I mean, obviously the carbon results in a much faster surface. Sometimes with this carbon that's a little bit faster, you have a soft carbon as well. So that can always give you a little bit more touch around the net. So yeah, it depends how you play the game. It depends on a player's style as to what carbon they would use.
Awesome, good to know. I'll have some more questions for you about different surfaces in a bit. It's 7 game points for Ma Long. Trying to scoop it up from under the table, but no dice, 11-3, a dominant performance for Ma Long to take his second game in a row. It's a 2-1 lead for the Olympic gold medalist and the standing defending world champion, Ma Long. Game 4 coming up right after this. Fan making a very cool sign. I believe it was from the last time that Ma Long won the major title. Jumped up on the table, pointed out to the audience. That was 2015 in Suzhou when Ma Long took the world championship. So we were talking a little bit about the surface and the material, the blades, from hinoki to all wood. And you were telling me a little bit about that, Gavin?
Yeah, I mean, the hinoki wood that's from Japan, the cypress tree, that gives a wonderful touch and feeling around the net. And obviously, with the game, the way it's going now, with so many players looking to flick out and dominate, it's important as well that you can put an emphasis on being able to feel the ball and the death touch around the net.
I think this next question that comes in is quite a good one for that point. The Wemo asks, do you think the Chinese players relax and explode before every shot to maintain powerful shots? You know, Gavin, I'll let you take this one as the color and the expert here.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, these guys, what's really important in the duration of a longer rally is that you breathe properly. A lot of these guys are actually exhaling as they hit, otherwise you'd get halfway through the rally and you don't have any energy left. A little bit like runners as well, it's important that you breathe really well, especially if you're in a long lobbing rally or a loop-to-loop rally. There's that little bit of exhale as you hit the ball.
And sometimes we can hear it a second after when Dima's playing. You know, it's funny, in weightlifting as well, you can think about it. When you're blowing out, when you're exhaling, is when you're putting in the most effort. So the breath is super important. And I think knowing how to balance relaxing and exploding with power is the most efficient way. Much like a hybrid vehicle, it knows when to use the gas and when to run on battery. Same with the players out here.
They really have to take care of their bodies for maximum performance. This could be an hour, 15-minute match. Although the speed of some of the points, the rally lengths, I think they're getting into it pretty quickly. There's not quite as much touch play over the table, and they're not, I guess they're both being stubborn to not back off the table, trying to stay in and stay aggressive, so the points are ending a little quicker than usual. To cover that ball as wide as Fan Zhendong gets in with that wrist and plays it out with the Chiquita. Ma Long reaching, but the way he reaches, it's almost like he leaves his feet behind so that he doesn't get out of position at all and can quickly just flex his body back up and recover. Well, Gavin, you had the experience of playing T-Mobile and you were saying how it's a whole different level out here. Are you excited to challenge one of these two?
Yeah, I mean, it's just really world-class stuff. And, you know, there's only so much you can see from a computer screen or a TV as well. Until you actually play these guys, it's really, really tough when you're out there on table one having to compete against one of these sensational players.
And that was Heinz the Hornman in full effect for the around-the-net shot that Fan Zhendong just hit that was chop-blocked back by Ma Long to win the point. Again, for those of you at home, the chop block is a last resort from the backhand that has some backspin and a lot of side spin on it, and it's tough to tell how much there is of which. Smart play. The ball was left out in front of Ma Long, and he uses a lot of wrist and a lot of spin to make a secure shot instead of going for a clear winner. Well, Gavin, when they showed Fan Zhendong's hand before the serve, it looked like it was shaking.
That's just the adrenaline kicking in. Massive amounts of adrenaline go into all sports, really, to get yourself fired up and to be able to play at this really, really high level.
And again, for those of you at home who are a little bit newer to table tennis, the wiping of the hand on the table is to wipe the sweat off and make sure they have full grip. Right idea from Ma Long, one to the middle, then deep to the backhand, but it goes long off the net. How big of a factor do you think nerves are playing right now, Gavin?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, scoreboard pressure. I think Fan Zhendong will be slightly more anxious, a little bit nervous now.
I don't know about you, but after that exchange, which was quite impressive, Ma Long had a little bit more time here, and it seemed like he really just tried to do a bit too much and hit it harder than he needed to. Which is tough to say, because even 80% for Ma Long is so fast. And a timeout. Remember, neither player has a coach in their corner, as they are both from the same national association. Yesterday, I had a chance to see Liu Guoliang in the practice hall with Fan Zhendong, who was lying down near the table for a bit, maybe visualizing and just relaxing before his match. But these two practicing together this morning. And also Wang Hao I saw coaching Fan Zhendong as he was practicing with Zhou Yu earlier on in the tournament. Little fun fact about Fan Zhendong, he won the Men's World Cup last year. Ma Long not participating. So, in that tournament, by winning that, it means Fan Zhendong, if he wins this, will only need to win the Olympics to become a Grand Slam champion alongside Ma Long, Konglinghui, Liu Guoliang, Waldner, and Zhang Jike, of course. I was like, who's the one I'm leaving out? The guy who got knocked out by Lee Song Soo earlier, the legend that half of the fans were here for on the first few days.
Yeah, Zhang Jike over the last few years, he was the big timer when it got to the big event. Interestingly, sometimes Zhang Jike not winning too many of the World Tour events, but when it got to the really nitty-gritty, the big, big events, he did step up in style, didn't he?
Absolutely. So this is pressure on both sides. Again, a 3-1 lead. You know, we saw with the women's singles final with Zhu Yuling and Ding Ning, it could have gone to Zhu Yuling being 3-1 up. And Ding Ning tying it up was crucial to sort of the momentum in that match.
pivotal moment of the match now for Fan Zhendong. He needs to keep the heat on. He needs to be hitting the ball fast, get the power on the ball. It's Ma Long that needs to change placements, change spins, change directions.
Excellent backhand, changing directions, just like you said, Gavin.
And we've not seen enough of that from Fan Zhendong so far. It's just been his trademark backhand on the diagonal, is what we've seen most of the time. But look at that lovely change.
So out of the timeout, Ma Long, you know, we talk about the first point out of the timeout as a morale boost. And Fan Zhendong stole the point. That can be pretty crushing. And he's got a second serve here to do it. That's an interesting call for the timeout on your opponent's serve. Wow, so we're seeing Ma Long getting a taste of his own medicine with these softer shots. For me, this is a real sign of confidence and mental maturity from the 20-year-old Fan Zhendong.
Fan Zhendong, he's improved over the last couple of sets. He started to get used to Ma Long's tactic of slowing it down, playing slower, arcing backhand topspins. So yeah, a lot of resilience shown, but really by both men.
Yeah, and it's something, you know, is Fan Zhendong might have more power. If you're all power, it's the versatility and the adaptability, say the improvisation that Ma Long brings to the game that makes him so tough. And look at this, baits him out, covers the middle of the table with the quick forehand, short stroke off the bounce for the winner.
Racket well out in front there.
And even that, the balance of Fan Zhendong, he was so far leaning over to the backhand corner. But because he's so fast, Ma Long still has the pressure to make that shot quickly or else Fan Zhendong will reach it again on the wide forehand. I love that let receive back into your own side of the table. A little bit of swag from Fan Zhendong shows some confidence and probably relaxes him a bit too. Big point to hang on to the 2-point lead. Again, once you've used your timeout, you want to make it worth it. You don't want to have to get deep in the match when you wish you had another one. Ma Long takes this game, timeout will have been well spent.
And that was interesting there. Ma Long, the last few points, has just been dribbling the backhand over the net. Suddenly there, introduced a lot of power, and it was successful.
Strong opening, but once again, Ma Long relentless to reach out and cover that forehand. You have to imagine that even with the arm fully extended, he almost loosens up his grip to extend the racket from his hand to reach that.
And we were saying earlier about the contact point. When you're going for a big shot like that, it's important you catch the ball right out the tip of the racket. That's where it's really going to accelerate.
Beautiful inside out step around forehand attack from Fan Zhendong. Well, he has this shot clearly in his arsenal. It's a shot we just haven't seen come up too many times so far this match.
Well, that looked spectacular, but actually that was just a percentage play. A big re-loop on the diagonal.
Right, he got a 75% from Ma Long, and he could see that it was coming long cross court, so he set up and turned around. Lightning speed from both sides. Four shots in a row exchanged as fast as anyone can hit them in the world. And again, their timing to stay close to the table for this. If you watch this replay time and time again and you only watch one player, just consider how little time they have between each stroke, which is why it's so important that they're able to have the muscle strength to not only relax but recover and set up again. Three game points for Ma Long to take a 3-1 lead. Comes back. The scooping shot from down below the table.
I'd love to see that point again, Gavin.
That was a real grease ball of a spin-up, and it almost had two bounces on the table. It was so low and slow.
Fan Zhendong with the punching. As soon as it comes up a little bit high, he's right back in at the table to take advantage and catch it before it drops. Here it is, the swoopy side spin from under the table. Catches a little bit off the top of the net. Still not an easy ball. Wasn't very high when he hit it. So two serves if Fan Zhendong can get this point. Sounded like there was a little conversation with the umpire. He's trying to look over at the hands of the umpire. Sometimes a service warning. Again, they are quite particular at this tournament, being the biggest tournament of the year. Strong start to the point, but Ma Long was just too good, moving wide to the forehand, and it's 11-8 for the Dragon. It's 3-1. This could be the last game of the men's singles event for the World Championships. Stay right here. Game 5 coming up. Starts going around the stadium once again for the men's singles final. As we come back for game 5, we've got a question from Lex Anders. Does hashtag Ma Long take the lead because he is preparing his attacks through avoiding the backhand of Fan Zhendong? Hashtag Fan Zhendong.
Well, he's certainly avoiding the fast backhand-to-backhand exchanges. If he plays to the backhand corner, he's doing it with less speed and a little bit more spin. Obviously, then when he turns and plays his forehands, he's looking to go into the middle and forehand of Fan Zhendong.
Excellent counter, pins Ma Long right in the chest with the shot. When I say chest, I feel like it actually has to be to the left shoulder from the start of this for it to be a problem for Ma Long to turn on. Like he tried to go around the net there to the short side. Well, Gavin, if you're Fan Zhendong right now, you've got Fan Zhendong skill sets. What are you telling yourself before game 5?
Well, what you're looking to do, you know, all these guys can play at an unbelievable level. I think he needs to introduce a bit more pace into the rallies again. Sometimes even serving a fast serve and getting into a quicker exchange.
Interesting tactic here. You can see clear frustration as he pounds his hip. He had played out wide to the forehand of Ma Long. He brought it a good foot closer to the center of the table this time, maybe hoping that Ma Long would overrun it or not get such a full arm stroke, and it would set up the attack stronger for Fan Zhendong for the backhand corner. Beautiful shot, closing and really hugging around that ball to wrap around and play it to the short side for the winner, Gavin.
Super reloop there, and if we remember back to the previous game, when he stepped around that corner, he went safe and went on the diagonal. Not this time. Look at that shot.
He really has to fan the racket up and over and come down after the ball to keep it low to the short side. Again, less forgiveness, less margin for error. Nice change of pace from Fan Zhengdong. Now for me, this is going to be a key ingredient as well, but the placement has to be so perfect. That moment when you both realize you're on TV. So for both of these players, neither of them has been pushed to game seven so far in this tournament. And I do think that is one statement about how strong their games are, even against their compatriots. They just haven't been tested the way that they have the chance to test each other out here right now. And Fan Zhengdong really looking to take this game. You can see 5-1 that he's going to have to stay focused. But the way he's focused right now, this could go the distance. Nice change soft to the middle and then fast rocket cross court. I know we were talking about this before. On the road to the final, Ma Long has lost more games than Fan Zhengdong. 5 games have been lost by Ma Long and only 4 have been dropped by Fan Zhengdong.
But I think, you know, I think that's a good thing for Ma Long. He was pushed a little bit more in the run up to this final.
Wow! Oh, it doesn't come down so close. I thought it was over. Turning to you, Gavin.
I've seen moments like that before when I've played a Commonwealth Games. And one of my teammates, Stuart Crawford, he went up with the early shout of, yes, that's the end of the point. It certainly wasn't. And the ball came down onto the table. Not this time, though.
Pretty close to the net. If that comes down, you can bet the ball's going over the cameraman's head. So here's an interesting one. We've got a question from at Table Tennis Daily. Does Ma Long have any weakness?
I'd say his weakness at the moment, but only at this absolute elite level. He's lacking that little bit of power in the muscling exchanges with Fan Zhengdong. Struggling a little bit when it's just racket to racket on the diagonal.
You know, it's also been a rare occasion, but recently he was beaten by Jung Song-un of Korea at the Asian Championships 3-1. And I think part of that's mental game. I've seen him get tight a few times, and this is, of course, he is human being. As much as Timo Boll might say he's a machine and we all joke that he's from another planet, he's clearly human. He's just working so hard to be at the very top of, what, 1.3, 1.4 billion strong? Wow, the counter with the angle. And you know what? Let's make it 7 billion strong. He's the best in the world. But right now he's being challenged. That backhand down the line first from Fan Zhengdong again. It's slowed down. Look at the speed of the ball. Just like a trace of light.
And that's it. As soon as there's speed and pace on the rally, that's when you feel that Fan Zhengdong maybe has a 60% chance of winning the rally. See the perspiration there. It is warm down there.
So it was very important for Fan Zhengdong to play that ball so wide. You see Ma Long had to really reach and he tried to play it back cross court, whereas he otherwise might have tried to go down the line on this. I think maybe he was even thinking he would fool Fan Zhengdong, who would break over to cover the forehand. Otherwise, the obvious choice would have been to play the line. And that's at this level, you often see someone do the opposite of the obvious choice. Still a 4-point lead at the second towel break. Neither player going for the towel. Footwork definitely not a problem. The change of pace and Fan Zhengdong left with the ball that he doesn't go for the rip, tries to play a little soft. And you really have to worry about your placement, because if you leave it on the table slowly and Ma Long gets a forehand on it, it's a lot of pressure to keep the ball right down the line here. So Gavin, we're 2 points away from Fan Zhendong sending this into the sixth with some momentum, some confidence, and putting some real pressure on the dictator.
It's getting really interesting now. Fan Zhendong there just improving a little bit on the service delivery, keeping it just a little bit lower to the net.
That step around, we're seeing it more and more. He's taking some risks, it seems, with the backhand, playing in combination, just keeping it deep to the backhand and challenging Ma Long to try and play it back down the line.
And it doesn't matter how good someone's backhand is, if you're going forehand into someone's backhand, that should be enough.
Chop block doesn't land, 11-5, what a performance from Fan Zhendong. Again, his back against the ropes, and it will be for every game from here on out, but game six is coming up right after this. Back to the table for game six, and we start to talk and think about what it means depending on who wins for the future of the sport and who's going to be on top. Gavin, you were saying.
Yeah, I mean, for Fan Zhendong, he was to win this, you would fancy then the next 5 or 6 years that he could really dominate the sport. And in such a strong era, it is tough to be able to do that. But, you know, a guy so young to step in, take a world championship title, you would feel that he would then have the confidence to build on that. From Ma Long's perspective, if he was to win that, you would fancy then, you know, with that points accumulation, he could stay on and be world number one for at least another year.
Yeah, we really have to wonder, when is he going to slow down? You know, for a while, in my opinion, I thought by now Fan Zhendong would have been world number one. I've been really impressed with Ma Long to be able to stay on top of his game. You know, we've seen at 28 years old, when Fan Zhendong, or rather Zhang Jike, with injuries and other things through the 28, was just dealing with a lot of physical difficulties. And the way Ma Long plays, that's his greatest concern. He's said it in interviews, injury. And he manages to avoid it by staying really healthy and working hard. Shortens it up, plays it out to the forehand side of the table. A risky shot, but it pays off.
It doesn't matter how good your serves are or how good your short serves are, it's important to be able to mix them up, use that element of doubt.
You know, talking about if one player wins, I remember thinking as soon as Fan Zhendong beats Ma Long on the World Tour, it's over. Like a pinata, Ma Long will never beat him again. That hasn't been the case. The China Open, it was a 4-0 victory for Fan Zhendong, and Ma Long hasn't lost another one since, not on the World Tour. See how he got right in near the back of the table. If that one comes down, he's in great position to counter and spin it up.
Nice little change of serve there from Fan Zhendong. Notice how the last five games he's been serving into the short forehand. Suddenly they're serving a bit more on the diagonal, giving Ma Long a different look.
You know, you start to wonder what Ma Long's thinking. If this goes to game seven, I think we're going to see a very different Ma Long attitude-wise from the start. There's a little bit of defeat in that step, even the way he lets his head hang down for a moment. Of course, he's gathering his thoughts, but the shoulders shrug a little bit. He doesn't want to have to fight a seventh. He really needs to figure out what it takes to finish it here. Again, he was up 3-1. Be a tough way to lose a championship. Again, Ma Long playing this title could be a contender for the greatest of all time. I mean, he's just collecting. You know, if he wins the next Olympic Games, I think many will consider Malone to be the greatest of all time. But that's sort of the battle. Who can grab the big titles and the world championships? One of the biggest, right behind the Olympic Games. I think that conversation would have been the same, you know, if Zhang Jike had won the Olympics this year in Rio, or last year. Many people would have said he's the greatest of all time. And now Ma Long has what appears to be a better chance to earn that title. Sure, many people feel that he already is. Fun conversation among friends. And then, of course, you've got the future here at 20 years old, assuming Fan Zhendong could stay healthy. Maybe starting when he was about that age right there could be the next Fan Zhendong. Although the parents don't look so intense. Oh, there they forced his hand into that shake, working on the forehand stroke. The mom really wants him to be a champion. So Fan Zhendong up 3 points here with his second serve. Gavin, this is getting thick.
Yeah, Malong just looking over the last few points a little bit labored, wide to his forehand, and that's probably just that element of doubt, the deception coming in from Fan Zhendong's receive of service.
I think it was game four we saw so many times, and just throughout the match, that Malong has covered the wide forehand very well. Excellent placement, a bit of side spin as it bends into the body, wide on the backhand side for Fan Zhendong. As flexible as that upper body is and as strong as the legs are to support Fan Zhendong to do this, that shot is asking a lot.
And this is a very similar scoreline now to when Ma Long played Timo Boll. Timo Boll was in the ascendancy in the sixth set and Ma Long came roaring back. So let's see if that happens again.
Outstanding shot selection for Fan Zhendong, very bold. Ma Long starts to change the pace, and instead of rocketing the backhand into the backhand side like Fan Zhendong had done before, he quickly changes it up. It seems to catch Ma Long off guard. It's funny you brought up the Timo Boll match. You're right, I forgot. Timo Boll had a decent chance to go seven with Ma Long, which would have been absolutely insane. Again, the atmosphere for the sold-out crowd is electric here. Even the way Ma Long gives the ball back, I feel like, is just in line with the way his body language is right now on the court. Feeling a bit deflated, looking for answers. And if that doesn't win, if that's not an answer, I mean, you can understand the stress of Ma Long playing for placement deep out down the line on the forehand side.
And sports psychologists will tell you now, okay, you're maybe going to lose this set, you're 9-3 down. What's important now over the next 4 or 5 points is to keep going. Try and find a positive mindset so that you're ready at the start of the seventh set.
Very interesting stuff. There's some positivity.
You feel a lot better about yourself losing 11-8 than if you're dumped out 11-3 or 11-4 and you don't really feel how the game is going.
So remember, Ma Long was up 3-1. The last time he lost from a 3-1 lead was in 2009. And the power is there. Just in case you were curious who that loss was, it was against Xu Xin, the comeback king. At the Qatar Open, we saw Xu Xin yesterday, the devastating comeback, being down 5-10, saving 5 match points against the Dark Knight, Lin Gao Yuan. I think the only one more painful than that for the opponent was Jun Mizutani in Kuwait from down 4-10. Xu Xin 8 points in a row. Whoa! What just happened? That was the most insane touch shot I've seen. Look at this ball. Look how slow it is and how much side spin is on it. I mean, the chop block to set it up forces Fan Zhendong into submission for a defensive ball. He barely even touches that, just nicks it. That is absolute control. So devastating that it forces the timeout.
And there goes the myth that, that Chinese players don't have the flair or the touch or the talent. You know, that's absolute nonsense. Look at that. It's just that most of the time you see the Chinese players playing big and powerful shots. They can do all the other stuff as well. They can do some of the stuff that Voldner can do. And there's a big example of that right there.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more, Gavin. It's not that they're not capable of playing touch. They're playing the wisest strategy to win. And that's what it takes. It's a little bit like Moneyball. You look at what works and you stick to the plan.
Yeah, there was no hand of concrete there as he managed to caress round the side of the ball. Beautiful.
That is so incredibly risky. I think for anyone who's ever tried to hit a softball or a lob with heavy inside-out side spin on the forehand, feels really silly when they miss that easy ball. And Ma Long did it against a ball that was relatively low. Well, that might look like goma, popular Japanese word. It's actually goma, Go Ma Long, the dragon. It's tough when the seats are equally spaced to really lean into that. So let's see if this timeout pays off for Xiaopeng. Up 9-6 here. Oh, break off the top of the net, and it's 4 game points for Fan Zhendong. By the way, in case you don't speak Mandarin, Xiaopeng, little chubby, little fatty, a term of endearment, is the nickname for Fan Zhendong throughout China. Ma Long now hoping to use 2 serves. And he gets the first point, game point saved. The pressure continues to build.
Yeah, good miss from Fan Zhendong there.
Right, we talk about table tennis's decision making and shot selection, and you do sort of have to pat yourself on the back a little bit and say you can't second guess yourself on that or be upset about the fact that it didn't go in, but just be happy that you're making the right decisions. Oh man, Fan Zhendong, as Ma Long turns the corner, blasts it down the line, and we are going to a 7th and deciding game. It's the match we all wanted to see and the game we've all been waiting for. Call your friends, grab your snacks, and get comfy, because game 7 coming up right after this. Come back to the table. You can see where they've been hitting the ball on the table. Fan Zhendong mixing it up a bit more in that last game, and the score shows it. Now, Gavin, we were talking about basically the fact that Fan Zhendong went for the backhand on his second to last shot for the aggressive shot, how he felt more comfortable trying it again.
Yeah, definitely. You know, 4 set points. All you need is one of those, and you know, he needed to play positively. The muscle memory was there from the miss before. So yeah, all credit to him.
Short side of the table again, a big shot to start off the game. Game 7 again, the momentum with Fan Zhendong. Look at his legs, the knee almost touches the ground. He pulls that right foot so far back to be able to turn and play the short side. Once again, falling back from the table. It's down the line. It's the short side of the table for Fan Zhendong. Gavin, when is Ma Long going to pick up and start moving out to the forehand to cover and trust his backhand in the rally?
That's it. Yeah, just a little bit too slow, but you know, it was a good spin-up. He was expecting there that Fan Zhendong would play the backhand and would go into a backhand-to-backhand trade-off.
And that's one way to handcuff the opponent. Serve it really wide to the backhand. Fan Zhendong is not likely to go for the around-the-net shot on the opening. Not against Ma Long. You know, the last time a men's singles final at the World Championships went to seven games was a decade ago in 2007, Zagreb, Wang Liqin versus Ma Lin. Interestingly enough, Wang Liqin also came back from 3-1 down. Big point, and he's fired up. The dragon is breathing fire.
So even with this massive pressure on both of them, the first 4 points, nothing against the serve.
Clever idea, long push to start it off. But again, we're seeing different intensity out here. Fan Zhendong with his chole and his clenched fist looked right in the eyes of Ma Long. Again, great friends off the table. But right now, this fight, the gloves are off. Still playing fair.
When there's a bit of heat and a bit of pressure, just don't miss your third ball.
What was that, Gavin? What shouldn't they do?
Come on, Mr. Fan Zhendong.
Now, credit again to Ma Long for moving, anticipating well to cover the forehand. It adds extra pressure for Fan Zhendong, who has a plan. He's played it successfully wide out to the forehand many times, but seeing Ma Long waiting there makes you second guess yourself and try to play it even wider sometimes than is available.
And there's enough pressure on this as it is. So a good service delivery and a spin on the table. Sometimes you'll find that could be enough.
Full stroke, and just like you said, Gavin.
Because it's that added intensity now, the pressure is there. Both players, their hand is a little bit tighter. When a player's hand is tight, you want to be attacking.
And this is part of the reason we were saying earlier, the Chinese players, the top Chinese players, will play boldly near the very end of a close match, and it tends to work out in their favor. Let service, Ma Long with his hand in the air. Deceptively heavy underspin. Now, one thing we haven't talked about, because it hasn't been that relevant in the match so far, is the serves of Ma Long. They're so deceptive, but they're very subtle. They're not flashy. You know, Dima has some very iconic signature serves, and Ma Long's the pendulum serve almost always, the most traditional serve in table tennis, but still, with the third ball waiting and how difficult and subtle it is, it's just really an intimidating and important job for the receiver to try and read it well and touch it right.
And how brave that was. So many players, when they put in a big, fast service delivery, they then go for a short serve after it. Have the bravery to step in and do the same serve again.
Soft ball and spinning from Ma Long to take a 6-3 lead. First 2 points to Fan Zhendong in this game, and it's been back and forth ever since, but Ma Long is starting to run into a lead here. Remember, neither player has a timeout left, only one per side. Excellent combination. Soft and then turns the corner for the power shot. Gavin, I'm loving it.
The adrenaline has kicked in again. You could see in that service delivery, the racket of Fan Zhendong was shaking again. And hopefully, that's going to help him to bridge the gap. These 2 points that he's trailing at the moment.
Similar pattern, turns the corner, sets it up well. Excellent use of the serves to get into the point. It's like you said, Gavin, once you turn the backhand corner and get in a forehand, no matter how strong your opponent's backhand is, it should win the point. And he has twice in a row.
That's what all these footwork exercises are for. Get round there under this serious amount of pressure. Explosive, big, powerful forehand to the right area.
Right, and actually I misspoke. He's played it down the line to the short side. Even more challenging for the attacker. Well, look at this. 3 points in a row for Fan Jindong.
And I hope there it's not going down in the stats as an unforced error, that, because that kicked like a mule. You could see that really jumping off the table, that little flick out.
Absolutely, that was a very forced error, if anything. It was an earned point. I don't even think the word error should be in the sentence. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this is the first ever final in men's singles at a World Championships for Fan Jindong. Every point from here on out, Gavin.
Just wasn't the racket head acceleration there from Fan Jindong. And obviously, with this Nataku ball, sometimes just going a little bit flatter and a little bit more direct, you need to accelerate the wrist to make sure you have that arc on the ball.
So a second serve here to capitalize on, and it's crucial for Fan Jindong with Ma Long serves coming up. Oh, a break off the top of the net. He is so focused right now. I didn't even see him turn to apologize. He just immediately went down to his hand. I think thankful that he was able to take the point. And it looked like there when he was giving the ball back, he gave a little apology. Looked like Ma Long almost started to clench his fist for that.
Save your nets and edges until 3-all, 7-all.
Timeouts earlier, nets and edges later. That's the new trend for table tennis. We saw the hand shaking from Ma Long as well. The pressure on both sides. As many times as they've been in a relatively similar situation, everything changes when it's the World Championships. Also, when it's the player who's right behind you trailing and waiting to take your job as the world leader.
I think in this situation as well, when the hand is shaking, it is easier to get round and play forehands. It's very tough to have that touch and feeling on the ball for your backhand when the hand is definitely wobbling.
Big point! He takes it away. Gavin, that's a really interesting point you brought up about the forehand and the arm really doing so much that the hand is not quite as relevant as it is on the backhand side.
Is this a changing of the guard at the top of world table tennis?
Will the crown be handed down? Fan Jindong has two serves and could decide that with these two. Shot. How does the body bend like that? Fan Jindong just giving it his all to try to get a forehand into this rally. The grunt of Ma Long on that ball, and he's rebalanced quickly. His head just went from head height to about below the waist. His body contorted. Screenshots are going to be going up and amazing photos from that. But Fan Jindong will injure himself, do whatever he has to take this title. There can't be too many points left. Save nothing. And it goes long. Ma Long leaves it dangling off the forehand side, an uncomfortable ball. Will Ma Long rob this once again?
What was the number one rule under pressure? After a service delivery, do not miss your third ball. You don't miss that at a top world level, you don't do that in club level as well. If you're at 3-all, 8-all, 9-all, massive number one rule.
And while that is a great rule, we also have to remember Ma Long is waiting there for the fourth ball attack for the counter, and it was quite a receive to an uncomfortable place. 9-all in game 7, ticket holders with the best investment of the year. Last two serve combination we will see for Ma Long. Whoa! Backhand to backhand, the challenge. There was a shout from the crowd in the middle of that. Quite shocked to hear that, especially here. But to recover that ball way wide on the backhand side and keep it in play and deter the inside out forehand. So Fang Zhengzong is pointing. I'm really curious what it is. Oh, I guess just where the ball went, that it went behind the scorekeeper, the assistant umpire's score booth.
Yeah, but there was a massive shout there. We could even hear that from our commentary position. I don't know if that was really on, but obviously both players zoned in. Adrenaline is high at the moment. Maybe they didn't even hear it.
Quite possible. The focus we've seen from these two, uncanny. Ma Long with championship point. What a way to save it! Unbelievable point! The point of the match is against match point! Xiaopeng on fire, and Ma Long gave everything into that point, and still it wasn't enough to take down world number two right off the bat. The backhand, two turning the corner, and finally a shot so wide, Ma Long a little bit farther from the table, and it costs him 85 kilometers per hour. That's the highest number I've seen on screen this tournament, Gavin.
That is adrenaline. Get that number up even more. We might even see something up in the 90s with the amount of adrenaline that's been packed into this match.
Deuce in the seventh, Fang Zhengzong with the serve. And it goes loose. Look at the eye contact. That's the biggest celebration I've seen mid-match. Ma Long is ready. He is so ready to take this, but it's not over yet. And Fang Zhengzong proved that down 9-10. What a release of air and energy. One more match point for the Dragon in red.
Do you serve short or do you serve fast into the backhand, run round blind and hit a forehand? It's up to him.
Short side of the table, Ma Long once again retains the title. The racket in the air. The dictator dictates how it goes. Deuce in the seventh, and he pulls a Fang Zhengzong on Fang Zhengzong for match point. Ma Long still on top of the world, 3 years unstoppable, and at 20 years old, he holds back Fang Zhengzong, who will remain number two in the world. What's it gonna be? We're gonna have an interview on the court from the man who shared his love with the world after winning the Olympic gold medal. He can't believe it. Absolutely tested down to the line here. Both hands in the air this time. And the racket that was tossed is collected along with the title. What a performance, Gavin.
He did so well on match point there. He ran round blind off the serve. He gave himself lots and lots of space to rip that forehand. Ballsy, really, really positive. And look at him now celebrate.
And this is not the first time we've seen this gesture. Ma Long held the flag with Zhang Jike, shared the flag of China to hold up as a team after winning the Olympic Games in Rio. And once again, immediately calls over Fang Zhengzong, the runner-up, to share this moment with him. A painful moment for Fang Zhengzong, but a moment of honor for China and the two best players in the world raising the best flag in table tennis. Once again, there are the scores on screen. And I'll say it again, the best investment for a table tennis fan was a ticket to this match for the last day of the 2017 Liebherr World Table Tennis Championships live from Dusseldorf. Gavin, what a thriller.
Unbelievable the way that he managed to close that match out. Credit to both players. Right from the start, it was high, high quality. After half of the first set, when Ma Long was struggling to get into it, from then on, it was just exceptional stuff as he falls to the ground.
Good thing the racket didn't come down, but at this point, he would take it. If it had hit him in the head, he probably wouldn't have even noticed with all the elation he's feeling right now. It's not the first time we've seen him roll back, although he didn't complete it after the neck injury he did. a few years back in celebration. Now look at the match, an hour and 16 minutes. We're going down live to Johnny Cowan for an interview with another world champion performance from the standing and defending world champion Ma Long.
The Belfast backhand.
Wow, 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 what an incredible men's final. The winner comes through, it's Ma Long of China. Was für ein Spiel, what a match, incredible, incredible. Ma Long, world champion, how do you feel?
世界第一有什么感想?
还是非常开心吧。 同时也觉得很累，能够经过这样一场比赛，我觉得是这辈子最值得留念的一场球。
He says he's very happy, obviously, but also super tired, and he feels like to be able to experience a match like this is worth remembering for his entire life.
Fantastic. I think we will all remember that one, Ma Long. Everybody in the venue, wir werden das erinnern, das ist sicher. We're going to remember that one, that is for sure. Ma Long, is that the craziest, maddest match you've ever played?
这是你打过最疯狂的比赛吗？一场？
我想这应该是我这辈子最疯狂的一场比赛。我想以后也不会再出现这样的球了。
He says this is definitely the craziest he's ever played and he'll probably will ever play in his entire life. He doesn't think he'll play like this again ever.
Wow, it was incredible. Van Zen, that was amazing. Ma Long, world champion!
Well done, Ma Long.